Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
You've got Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. We will give you our toll-free lines. We're going to talk about internet addiction. That is on the way here tonight. Apparently, they're talking about making this a new official disorder.
Internet gaming.
Internet gaming addiction. Yeah, okay,
looking at kitties on the face web and looking at all the drama that's going on in whatever group you're a part of. That's a whole nother thing that'll be coming down the pipes pretty soon.
Okay, so internet gaming disorder. I definitely want to hear more about that. It's Ian with you tonight.
And Conan.
And Conan, you brought the story in, but actually you wanted to tell us about what's going on over in China first with a bizarre point system that the government apparently is implementing that will give you points if you love the government.
Correct.
Did I get that right?
That's exactly where they're going with this.
Tell me more about that. Where are you getting the story from?
This particular article is over at BBC.com. I've seen a couple different. This is the long article. I think they did the best job.
All right.
In most countries, the existence of a credit system isn't controversial, and we have our own credit system here in the States here. And,
sure.
I know callers have called in and they have problems with it, and I think it's a necessary function, and I think it can be manipulated and taken. It can be hurtful. But I think it's a necessary system that we need in order to, you know, make decisions.
Well, yeah,
financial decisions.
In the absence of a government, and it's not the government that runs the credit system, but you know, in the absence of the current status quo, people will still want to know things about other people. Like, is this person reliable? Is this mm-hmm. person coming in to work for me?
You're going to want criminal background checks. Yeah. You're going to want financial background checks.
Is the person reliable from a, you know, just day-to-day, will they show up kind of thing? And further, are they reliable financially if you're going to loan them money, that kind of thing? And actually, the government has stood in the way of being able to learn things about people. Mm-hmm. So, like, if you are trying to interview a potential employee, there's certain questions you can't ask them. And there's also certain questions you can't ask their former employers either.
Right, right.
So it's very, very hard, actually, because of government regulations, to really learn what you need to learn about a potential employee.
And, of course, the people who benefit from this type of law are the people who are usually breaking the law. They're usually doing damage. So if I want to find out if a renter is going to screw up my house and some law is in effect that says I can't look at that particular piece of background information because some politician was lobbied by the people mm-hmm. To pass that law, well, that who does that hurt?
So
that hurts the guy with the house, and then, of course, I'm going to get screwed over probably. And
renter's rights just really screws over landlords in a lot of ways. So, and I'm not saying that, you know, renters don't have rights. Obviously, everybody has rights. But, you know, here we are back on the issue of the credit reports. There are a lot of people who have issues with the credit reporting system, but a lot of those come from sort of the way the whole credit game works in the first place.
Like getting stuck with your dad's bankruptcy or something because you have the same name and not being able to get out from under that big old rock.
Well, there apparently are processes to this, mm-hmm. but I imagine they're very slow and unwieldy. And then you also have issues if somebody steals a credit card and then they go and they start charging things up, then you've got to go through a process of trying to undo that damage to your name and whatever account, whatever number your credit report has associated with it can be damaged by other people who would be interested in stealing your identity. So a lot of those things you can actually solve with Bitcoin, which allows you to only you can authorize transactions with Bitcoin. One of the important differences, and I realize we're getting a field of the point here, we'll come back to China in a moment. But one of the major differences between Bitcoin and the old school credit system, the credit card business, is that there's no central authority with Bitcoin. And it's not a pull system, it's a push system. So what I mean by that is when you swipe your card at the point of sale at some business, the business is actually pulling from your account. They're going and they're using their payment gateway or whatever, and they're pulling funds from your credit card account, basically.
Your account. It's not a credit. They don't have a credit. I don't think they have a Bitcoin credit system set up.
No,
yet,
I'm not talking
they?
About Bitcoin yet. I was talking about credit cards. So when you swipe your credit card, they are pulling from your account. Now, you've authorized that by swiping the card. But if the business wanted to, they've got all your information. They could just go ahead and pull another one.
Right. We've seen lots of instances where, for example, in restaurants where you have the option to tip via the credit card. And so you have your amount paid for the meal, and then you have a location for the tip. Mm-hmm. And sometimes waitresses or waiters who are a little peeved have actually tacked on a few digits onto that tip.
That's one way to do it. Another way
and
is
of course
to
the customer doesn't see it until he gets his statement at the end of the month.
Right. And then you've got to dispute it.
And if you don't, a lot of people don't even look at their silly statement. So sometimes I think that's probably taken place a lot more often than is reported.
Yeah, and that's a good point. And also one of the other things they can do is just copy down the credit card information.
Yeah.
I mean, if you've got back in the old days you had the old chunk machine where you get the carbon paper and you have to run this thing over top of the card. You literally had a physical imprint of the card.
Yeah, I've used one before.
In that case. And, even though those machines aren't common these days, a clerk who has a free 30 seconds could still just jot down all your info. And now they actually have, I've seen on Facebook, people taking pictures of, or sharing stories about these, what do they call them? Skimmers, I think they're called.
Mm-hmm.
Like somebody will attach a device to like a gas pump. And,
or an ATM machine.
Or an ATM machine.
So every time you slide your card in there, it gets your information.
It's copying your info.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, in that case, the pump operator has no idea this has been done. It's some scam artist that has attached this device to steal people's credit card numbers. And once they have the 16-digit number, I think it's 16, once they have 14 or whatever it is.
4 times 4, 16.
Yeah. Once they have the 16-digit number, the CVV code from the back, and the name on the card, the only other piece of data that sometimes is requested is a zip code. That's the only piece of data that's not actually on the physical card. But most of the time when you do some online checkout or whatever, it's not required that you enter your zip code.
Right.
So some places have greater levels of security than others. And so my point being that as long as the person has that data, they can authorize as many transactions as they want to on your credit card. Whereas with Bitcoin, the security is a lot better. Now, any amount of security is only as good as the person who's implementing it.
Right.
So if you, let's say you have Bitcoin on your phone and you don't have a password on your phone, and further you don't have a password on your Bitcoin wallet, well then, okay, if somebody gets their hands on your phone, then yes, they are going to be able to authorize you sending money out. But one of the differences between credit cards and Bitcoin is if you have all the Bitcoin info, meaning that you've got my wallet ID, you can't authorize me remotely to send you money.
Right.
That's just not possible. You'd have to have my private key in order to be able to authorize to send money. And even then, you can still only push money out from your Bitcoin wallet. You cannot take money from someone's Bitcoin wallet. That's just not possible with the system that Bitcoin is based on. So Bitcoin solves a lot of the credit card issues with chargebacks. That's not possible with Bitcoin. If you haven't looked into it yet, it's a decentralized currency, and it is kind of taking the world by storm. It's had an amazing resurgence in price over the last few months here. It's now up to around $440-something,
ooh, wow,
$450 per Bitcoin. And it's looking good. The future of Bitcoin is bright. More companies than ever are accepting it. We just had a Bitcoin meetup yesterday. We went to a local sports pub here in Keene. So what we're doing is we're doing like a floating Bitcoin meetup. Once a month, we're going to go to a different restaurant and pitch them on accepting Bitcoin. Now, usually the manager isn't going to be who you're dealing with in these circumstances. So the bartender there, he said he'd pass along a card. So we have these Bitcoin info kind of intro cards that we hand out to folks. We gave him one of those. But then I asked the dude, I said, hey, I gave him a cash tip on what I purchased. And I said, I'll give you more, a larger tip. And it wasn't a bad tip either. I gave him a decent cash tip. And I said, I'll give you more if you'll put a Bitcoin wallet on your smartphone. And of course, I was there with three or four other people who are also willing to mm-hmm. tip an additional Bitcoin to him. So he was willing to do it. I told him, hey, you can go spend this right over at the corner news store here in Kings. We actually got a physical locations that take Bitcoin here.
Yeah, start them out slow with something like tipping. Not the whole check. But
exactly.
Just the tip. And
he said yes. So we gave him $5 extra.
Was this
tip.
A young person, old person?
Let's say early 30s, late 20s. Good. So yeah, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live. The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the new Healing Our World is a great gift this Christmas for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Concerned about harmful contaminants in your water? Look to ProPure, the most trusted name in gravity water filtration systems. ProPure, with the silver-infused Pro-1 G2.0 filter, removes over 200 contaminants, including VOCs, heavy metals, chloramines, pesticides, pharmaceuticals, fluorides, and radiologicals. We don't just say it, we back it up. The Pro-1 G2.0 filter is NSF 42 certified and independently tested to meet NSF 53 and P231 standards. ProPure water, the way nature meant it to be. Clean, crisp, and refreshing. Purchase with confidence in quality, performance, and customer service. Take advantage of our biggest holiday 25% off sale going on now. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com. Or call 800-544-3533. 800-544-3533.
Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a longtime supporter of antiwar.com. This past November, Roberts & Roberts donated all the profits of their precious metal sales from Armistice Day and Bitcoin Black Friday to antiwar.com. Well, that wasn't enough, and they're doing it again. From now until December 23rd, use coupon code PEACEONEARTH, all one word, and every dollar over the wholesale cost from all products from that purchase will go to antiwar.com. Randolph Bourne said, "War is the health of the state, and Roberts & Roberts believes that banks are its sustenance. Banks drive war. Why use their money? By investing in gold, silver, and Bitcoin, you are exiting the corrupt system that enables war. Use coupon code PEACEONEARTH when you shop online at rrbi.co now through December 23rd and help support antiwar.com and the cause of peace this holiday season. Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, rrbi.co. That's rrbi.co. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts & Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you're invited to join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us via Skype as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Conan.
And, of course, we'll talk to you about anything that happens to be on your mind. But coming up, Conan, you're going to tell us more about this Chinese points system that apparently is being, these points are being handed out to people who love their government.
Oh, it's not being handed out. They have to earn it.
Yeah, see, I don't know much about it. So tell me more about it here in a moment. But I also want to let you know about the Liberty Health Share. It's a movement in healthcare today, of people that are ready to stand up and take charge of their healthcare. People like you who are tired of paying too much for healthcare and getting too little. Folks who are standing up for their values and letting their conscience make decisions based on timeless principles. It's a movement that's sweeping the nation, and you should be part of it. Liberty Health Share is leading the movement of people who are looking for an alternative to traditional health insurance. It's a healthcare sharing organization of people who are sharing the cost of healthcare in an easy and efficient way. Hence the name, Liberty Health Share. Choose your own doctor, your own hospital, and live out your values in healthcare. Join the movement and change healthcare for good. Go to joinlhs.com. Or call them toll-free at 800-722-8041. That's Join LHS, like Liberty HealthShare, joinlhs.com, or 800-722-8041 for Liberty HealthShare. As we continue here, a story coming from, where was it, Conan?
This one is BBC.com.
All right, what do you got?
So anyways, we talked about the existing financial credit system that most people are familiar with. We have that here in our own country. But China is taking the whole concept a few steps further. The Chinese government is building an omnipotent social credit system that is meant to rate each citizen's trustworthiness. By 2020, everyone in China will be enrolled in a vast national database that compiles fiscal and government information, including minor traffic violations, and distills it into a single number ranking system for each citizen. The system isn't yet in place. For now, the government is watching how 8 Chinese companies issue their own social credit scores under state-approved pilot projects. One of the most high-profile projects is by the Sesame Credit. And Sesame, I believe, is a... well, I think they also run some games, some internet games, like Blizzard Asia, the Asian Blizzard Department. The financial wing of Alibaba, they also do Alibaba, which is the Amazon, Chinese Amazon.
Yeah, I'm familiar with Alibaba.
With 400 million users, Alibaba is the world's biggest online shopping platform.
Interesting.
It's using its unique database of consumer information to compile individual social credit scores.
So hold on. So Alibaba is part of Sesame?
They are, I believe they're run by the same, they're a wing of Sesame.
And this is the company that's sort of piloting this program for the government?
Well, they say they have 8 Chinese companies, and this is the one that they link to, the Sesame company.
All right.
So very interesting. Users are encouraged to flaunt their good credit scores to friends and even potential mates. China's biggest matchmaking service, Bahe, has teamed up with Sesame to promote clients with good credit scores, giving them prominent spots on the company's website. A person's appearance is very important, explains Bahe's vice president, but it's more important to be making a good living. Your partner's fortune guarantees a comfortable life. Could you imagine putting your credit score on your dating profile right next to your picture?
Which I can see some people would do it.
Yeah, if you've got a good credit score, that might actually be a winning combination.
I don't think that's why you would want to attract someone. So
I don't. Well, maybe you're just in the getting them in the bed for a night department. I know that they're out there. More and more of Bahe's 90 million clients are displaying their credit scores in their dating profiles, doing away with the idea that a credit score is a private matter. Mm-hmm. So they've already come to the conclusion I just came to.
Would you do that? I mean, you, the listener, would you put your credit score, or do you put your credit score on your dating profile?
The question is how many people with good credit scores are in the dating scene?
How many
of them are comfortably partnered up already, paying mortgage payments? I'm thinking a lot of people with bad credit are the ones who are living life and they're out there. And
I wouldn't jump to that conclusion, Conan. I mean, just because you've got a good credit score doesn't mean you have had a good string of relationships or that you've managed to keep it together in one relationship. I don't think that having a good credit means that you're necessarily good with people.
It's the same if you had a nice, you're driving around a nice car. It doesn't necessarily mean that you're a good person or right. that you're, you know, you got all your digits together.
I mean, all good credit really shows is that you pay your bills on time.
Which right? I guess could be a really good, that's a good characteristic.
There's no doubt that's a good thing, but being able to pay a bill doesn't mean that you're good with people, right? That just means you can pay your bills.
Mm-hmm. So, however, Sesame Credit will not divulge exactly how it calculates its credit scores, mm-hmm. explaining that it is a complex algorithm. The company refuses to give an interview to BBC, citing concerns that the government would refuse to grant a permanent license to issue credit scores if it engaged with the foreign media.
Hmm.
So they've got some special system going on.
Shutting it down. I mean, they're shutting down discussion about this. I mean, they're afraid to even talk because they don't want to lose their favor with the Chinese government.
Mm-hmm. Well, they still have another 4 years to actually implement this full scale. So they're probably still working out bugs. And mm-hmm. I mean, we will eventually find out everything that is involved.
But this is more than just credit, right? This isn't just about paying your bills on time.
No, this
new system.
All right,
in China.
And I think we're getting to that. Instead of their spokesman issued a statement discounting persistent rumors that the organization monitors users' social media activity when assessing their social credit. Sesame Credit tracks financial and consumption activities of our users. This is a quote from this guy. Materials published on social media platforms do not affect our users' personal Sesame Credit score, explains spokesman Miranda Schreck.
Hmm.
And I was of the opinion that, in some other articles that I read, that they were in fact monitoring like Facebook posts. And if you were monitoring anti-government type posts, like Tiananmen Square pictures, it would actually lower your credit score.
You're saying you saw that in another story, but in this story, they're flatly denying that, saying, no, we don't do that.
The Sesame representative just flatly did away with that accusation.
Well, you know, maybe it's not happening yet, but maybe that'll be something they add in later on. Let's go to Laura in Colorado. You can share your thoughts on this. Laura, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm glad you guys are having this discussion. You all have some of the greatest discussions on this show, and
thanks.
I just want you to know that I love listening to you. This is the first time I've ever called you. Wanted to tell you, I'm from the age of, you know, graduating high school in 1980, you
okay.
know, and then going to college through the 80s and whatnot. And one of the things that became very irritating to me early on was I wasn't married for very long, and I got divorced, and I found out that my credit was totally ruined, even though my husband and I had two or three car loans during that period of time. Everything was perfect.
You should have had good credit, but it was ruined. I want to hear the rest of your story. Stand by, Laura. We're going to bring you back. And you're welcome to join us here as well. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Lockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. LockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at LockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. LockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
If you or someone you care about loves outdoor adventure, then check out slingbow.com for some unique holiday gift ideas. That's slingbow.com, where we have some innovative new products for the archer, hunter, or bow fishing enthusiast in your family. Now through January, use the promo code HOLIDAY to get free shipping in the US or Canada. And from all of us at Slingbow Industries, have a safe, joyous, and peaceful holiday season.
Americans across the nation made their voices heard this week as they demanded more mind-blowing guitar solos. Calling for the solos to be, quote, face-meltingly cool and go on for well over 10 minutes, Americans stressed that all guitar solos from now on should be equally as kick-ass as those in Van Halen's Hot for Teacher and AC/DC's Thunderstruck, or even better.
It should start out really slow, you know, and then get faster and faster until they're all the way up at the top of the guitar neck and bending the notes like crazy, so it's like, and then there's all this awesome pyrotechnic stuff going off in the background. They should all be like that.
And in this week's local news, a report noted that on its surface, Glenbrook, Ohio is a small town like any other, a peaceful, all-American town. And yet, the report's authors added, if you only look closer, what you find may surprise you. In other news, a man is just having one of those decades where he doesn't feel like doing anything.
This is the Onion News Network.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 90% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Got Free Talk Live, and you can join us right here. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You know, I think libertarians generally like the idea of reputation ratings. That's sort of something you'll hear people talk about in the liberty movement.
I think it is the pillar that keeps everyone in check. I mean, people talk about anarchy and they're like, well, if we don't have laws and all this, what's going to keep someone from throwing a bottle through my window? This pillar, your standing in the community, the first time that happens, you're going to be outed. You're not going to be shopping at the local grocer. You're not going to be able to do business with all of my friends. So this is the actual, you know, in huge communities where you can escape, where you can hide in the shadows and go do business with someone else.
Right.
That's where that fall apart. But with technology where it is, it's becoming harder and harder to escape into the shadows. Just, you know, hey, I've killed someone, or I did some other financial evil. I can just escape to the next state over, and no one knows who I am. I can start my whole life over. Well, that's becoming harder and harder these days.
That's true, and it definitely does keep, I think, most people in line. But obviously, a psychopath doesn't care about their reputation in the first place. Let's go back to the phones and the fun. Linda is with us in Colorado. We switched you on to what is hopefully a better line here. Linda, are you there?
Yes, and it's okay. Ian, it's Laura.
Oh, I'm sorry. So, I'm sorry. I should have
written. That's okay.
You know, I even wrote
that's
it down.
All right.
Shame on me. Laura, go ahead with your thoughts. You were going to tell us something about credit, and you barely had a chance to get a few words out. So go ahead.
Okay. Well, you know, I graduated high school back in like 1980 and went through college and then in the 80s. Okay. And, you know, after several years of being married, I worked full-time. My husband worked full-time. We both bought the Corvette. We both bought the brand-new truck. We both bought the house. But when I got divorced, I found out that I was considered a quote-unquote secondary, and I had no credit, even though I had worked all those years and equally contributed to everything that our household had purchased. So I was extremely irritated over that. Then later, I got another student loan, went back to college a second time, and the second time I went to college was for a manufacturing type of degree. And, of course, when NAFTA got signed in the 90s, you know, 50 million manufacturing jobs were gone. So I ended up with a quality control degree in waiting tables to raise my two children, and eventually I defaulted on the student loan. Well, continuing to try to get a job in my field. Then I found out as I was going along and trying to get work that the employers were using the quote-unquote Fair Credit Reporting Act, and they would check your credit prior to offering you a job. So it was just like no matter what you did, if you had a bad mark against you because maybe a poor choice that you had made or whatever, I mean, I considered the quality control inspection thing in the aerospace industry to be a very poor choice. Of course, at the time when I got my education, it didn't look like a poor choice, but it sure turned into one. But what ended up happening was for many, many years, I could not get a job in my field because of this Fair Credit Reporting Act. Now, after 2008, after everybody lost their house to these foreclosures, then all of a sudden they made it illegal for employers to check people's credit. But look at the 20 years of lives that were ruined. And of course, once you've been out of your field for a long period of time, no one will even look at you. You can't even buy a job in that field. And so, you know, there because of these horrible laws that that allowed these corporations to get down into your intimate details of your life that maybe you didn't want anyone to know that you'd defaulted on a student loan or you didn't want anyone to know you'd been divorced and that kind of thing. But when they could check your credit, they could find out all of those things about you. And now it's so bad that they can basically just go on the computer and find out just about anything they want to about anyone. And I'm just wondering
All they have to do now is just go to your Facebook page because you have all your information
But shouldn't they be allowed to do that? I mean, I don't think the government is the solution here to say, no, corporations, you can't research this person. You can't learn about what they can and can't or they have or haven't done in the past. I don't think that they should be precluded from that. But ultimately, it sounds like the real failure is the credit system because you were saying you were making payments on the truck loans or whatever and that didn't build credit for you for some reason. Is that right?
Well, no, the original things that, you know, cars and houses and things like that. No, I was told when I went down after I got divorced and tried to literally buy a television out of a little tiny store on a revolving charge and was told, no, you don't have any credit. And I just couldn't believe that they were telling me that. And they said, well, if you were married and divorced, then you were a quote unquote secondary on these accounts and you don't matter. And I was just furious. But let me tell you what it taught me to do, guys. I have zero credit rating as far as I know because since the late 1980s, I haven't tried to borrow any money. I've saved and bought everything I wanted by saving money, even though I was I was working low-paying jobs. I was buying older cars, but it didn't matter. But let me tell you what happened. It completely relieved me of debt slavery.
Yeah.
And so it really was a blessing from God when
in
you
disguise.
Look back on it,
yep.
You know.
I think you're right about that. I think a lot of people see things that what are happening to them as bad things, but then later on you can actually look back and have some perspective and see that there actually was a good side to it. And I'm glad you were able to do that. And I totally agree, by the way. That's how I've always lived my life. I've never gone into debt for anything except for a house, just because
it's impossible.
Pretty much have to.
Yeah, it's just too much money.
But you know, as far as buying a car, as far as buying a TV or whatever, if I don't have enough saved, and I mean like 5 or 10 times the amount. Like, I want to have enough in savings, but also savings left over. I don't want to just, you know, save up to buy a TV and then be back to zero. I want to have 5 times that amount or some arbitrary amount to where I feel comfortable, like, okay, I can spend this amount on a TV, and then if something unexpected happens, I'll still have money in savings later on. And most people, they're not taught these habits at all. They're not taught by their parents, and they're not taught by the government school system. That's for damn sure.
If you monitor how our own local, state, and federal government behave, they don't seem to know either. So this is who we're learning. Here the people who are in charge, and our children are learning these bad behaviors from our own big papa government.
And then you've got a situation where, I don't know what the numbers are, maybe we can look this up because it is an interesting statistic, where the average American is in debt by a few thousand, if not several thousand dollars.
If the student debt is over $1 trillion, it surpassed credit card debt. So credit card debt is about at $1 trillion, U.S. credit card debt. That's quite a lot of money. This is the horizon that we live in. This is the environment that we live in. It's debt, and you have people actually coming out, economists actually coming out saying, "Hey, don't worry, debt is good." They actually come out and they write articles on how debt is good, and that you have to, in order to invest in your future, you have to go into debt to do so. Which is ridiculous.
It's sick. According to Fool.com, according to the U.S. Census, there are approximately, the average family has $7,600 in what they call revolving debt. I'm not sure what revolving debt is, but it doesn't sound good. $7,000+, and that's the average family. Was there anything else, Laura, you wanted to share about your experience?
Well, yeah, the one thing I wanted to say and throw in about the student loan debt thing also, and let me encourage anyone out there, if anyone out there wants to get out of debt, they can do it. I don't care for Dave Ramsey too much, but he is right. Eat rice and beans. Get out of debt as fast as you can. And don't grow any debt. I mean, nowadays you can go out and go to a thrift store and buy a TV. Back in the 80s, that wasn't possible. But, you know, it was what we did learn from this whole thing, too, was that back in the 90s, a lot of people that had to take lower-paying jobs that had been in better manufacturing jobs until NAFTA came along, they had to take lower-paying jobs in other types of fields. They would try to negotiate with the student loan people and say, look, I can't make that student loan payment, but I could make a lesser payment because I'm in a lesser job. And in the 1990s, the student loan people would not negotiate at all. You either made that whole payment or they would default you.
Laura, good call. Call tonight. I really appreciate hearing from you. Feel free to call us again because I know it was your first time tonight. Appreciate that. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon. But now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Did you know that home break-ins increase more than 100% during the holidays? It takes just 10 seconds for an intruder to kick in your door. But police response to a home alarm system is more than 20 minutes. And intruders are in and out of your home in 5 minutes. Thieves know that you're not home and have presents inside just waiting to be taken. And if you are home, how safe will you feel with an intruder lurking inside with your family? That's why police across the country are recommending you use Door Armor. Proven to withstand the force of a battering ram, Door Armor keeps intruders out. It's easy to install and barely visible, and your Door Armor is guaranteed for life. Go to invasionstopper.com for a very special buy one, get one at half off deal. These savings are for a limited time and only available to GCN listeners. Protect your valuables and loved ones this holiday season. Go to InvasionStopper.com now. That's InvasionStopper.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Cryptocurrency and peer-to-peer tech developments happen fast. Stay in the loop with The Daily Decrypt, a new video channel and podcast that will keep you on top of the latest innovations in crypto finance, security, networking, transportation, and gadgetry like drones and 3D printers. Subscribe to The Daily Decrypt on YouTube and SoundCloud and be an early adopter of the future. The Daily Decrypt.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We're talking about debt. And the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Initially, we were discussing the credit system and this new system that the Chinese government is looking at implementing. They're going to do it over a number of years. And basically, this new system in China is going to rank more than just your credit, your kind of classic monetary score. They're also maybe going to be looking at social questions.
Yeah, right now, they are most definitely monitoring financial companies who are monitoring their own customers and their financial acquisitions.
Mm-hmm.
But the Chinese government, intends to take it to another step, and they want to monitor social aspects and, of course, the financial aspects, but also, most importantly, the social aspects and whether the people of China are trustworthy, government trustworthy, and whether they can be trusted to, you know.
Meaning their government obedience score, basically.
Exactly.
Right? So that's coming to China, and maybe that'll expand from there to other countries. Because, as you know, a lot of governments keep an eye on other governments, and they see what kind of, you know, nonsense they can get away with, and they try implementing it where they are. So, but then we had Laura calling from Colorado talking about her experience with credit, which has been an absolute nightmare, but ultimately led her down the road of being fiscally responsible and actually saving money because she couldn't get credit. She went in a different direction and became fiscally responsible and actually learned how to save. And that set her free in a lot of ways.
In a lot of ways, it hurt her, but didn't kill her and made her stronger. And so she figured out some things on the way. And I wish a lot of the millennials would figure this out because it's coming. They're going to, you know, a lot of them moved back with their mommy and daddy who've already figured it out. And they still haven't, you know, taken the hint yet.
That's the right time to figure it out is when you don't have a bunch of payments to make. If you're living at home with your parents, you should be socking away big time bucks. I mean, when I graduated high school, I had $10,000 in the bank because I didn't have to pay rent, and I was working. So pretty much all my paychecks went straight into the bank.
Yeah, how many 18, 19-year-olds can say that?
Not very many.
But how many 18, 19-year-olds back in your time could have said the same?
Not very many.
I'm thinking it was probably not very many. Right now, it's probably non-existent.
Well, yeah, not very many back then either, because, you know, most teenagers are too busy partying. They're not working like I was back then. So luckily, my parents did inculcate me with the idea of savings. When I was growing up, if I wanted to get some kind of a video game system or something, they would make me save up for it. Now they were giving...
Oh, yeah, I never got gifts. All my consoles... You know, I bought them. All my motorcycles, yep. I paid for. All my lawnmower that got me my jobs to make money, I paid for it. I mean, I would get loans, but I'd always be paying those loans back.
From your parents, you mean?
Oh, yeah. I can't afford a $300 lawnmower, you know. But
I see what you're saying. But yeah, my parents never gave me a loan for anything, but they did give me a weekly allowance that was contingent on me doing certain chores, so like taking the garbage out of the house. So I was being sort of paid for doing those household chores. It wasn't very much, but, you know, it all adds up, right? If you save it, you'll have something. And so I learned that pretty early on, and I think it's been very, very beneficial to me. And having savings sets you free from a lot of things. You know, the whole American debt system, and I do have the story here from Fool.com from 2015.
You know, I wouldn't say having a savings is what sets you free. I would say understanding what things are actually worth and actually paying for them with your own money.
Well, right.
That's what sets you free. That's what causes you to want to have savings, because you know what things are actually worth, and you know that bad things happen and that you might need something set aside for a rainy day.
Right.
And I mean, and everything in our society, in our economy, it's the exact opposite. Everyone is buying things on credit. Everything is getting things from somebody, welfare. And it's every level, by the way. It's not just poor people. It's every level of our system is correcting some sort of welfare. And so no one's actually paying for what they're, you know, purchasing.
Well, and then they get upset when they feel stuck where they currently are. Oh, I can't leave my, you know, this town. I can't leave this job. I'm living paycheck to paycheck. I've got to go to work. You know, I would love to leave this terrible job and go get another job, but I can't afford to pay the bills in between now and then.
And the only thing I can do is vote for Bernie. Because Bernie will save me. He'll reduce my student loan.
That's not gonna.
He'll get those corporate fat cats off my back.
I just saw a headline about Bernie wanting to increase not corporate taxes, but like workers' taxes.
Oh yeah, how do you like that?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know if he promised to never do that, but he has only been focusing on the corporates, and so now it's come down the pipes that he's after everyone. And I bet you a lot of people who support him and still support him. You're gonna say, well, you know, it's a necessary evil. You know, we all got to do our share. We all got to help out.
So if you're living this debt lifestyle, you might have yourself a fancy 60-inch widescreen television. You might have a fancy car, but ultimately you're stuck in whatever rut that you've dug in for yourself. If you are at a crappy job that you hate, well, guess what? You're not going anywhere because you got bills to pay. And you can't afford to have a missed paycheck or five missed paychecks or however long it would take you to acquire a new job. So in a lot of ways, debt is enslaving in more than one obvious way. Like, it's obvious that you're enslaved to the bank.
Oh, debt is slavery.
Yeah.
Plain and so it's the new. I mean, they might have gotten rid of racial slavery, but
right.
we've just entered into a new horizon, and that is money slavery.
I've got statistics here from Fool.com. The average American has this much debt. How do you compare? Many benefits have come from innovation, but the creation of a cashless society may not be one of them. After a brief respite following the Great Recession, shoppers are increasingly embracing credit again, and monthly debt payments are piling up. Consumer spending on clothes, cars, and condos has surged in the past few years as the unemployment rate has dropped and excessively tight bank lending standards have eased. According to the Federal Reserve, the amount of revolving credit outstanding, and you look this up, Conan, revolving credit is basically credit card style credit, where it's credit that's constantly offered to you. Once you get approved for the card, you just have access to it.
Unlike a bank loan. Or a loan in general. It's an everyday loan that you can use and until you mess it up,
right.
My credit card is revoked.
So a bank loan where you'd have to go in, you'd have to apply, and then, you know, you get approved and then you get X amount of dollars. And then if you want another loan, you'd have to apply again. In the case of this revolving credit, like a credit card, it's always there. Month after month, you can just keep racking it up. So the total amount, which reflects credit card debt primarily, is $882 billion in November of 2014. So this article came out earlier this year in 2015. up from $853 billion a year ago. That 3.3% growth outstripped the average American's income growth of 1.7% in the past year. So as usual, Americans are spending more than what they earn, and they're spending above what their increasing of their earnings is. So they're constantly behind the ball.
Yeah, and this directly mirrors our government.
Consumers, I mentioned the government's even worse, but consumers just aren't just borrowing more on their credit cards. They're also taking on more student loan, auto, and mortgage debt, too. Student loan debt outstanding has climbed from $1.21 trillion to $1.3 trillion. Auto loans outstanding have grown from $866 billion to $943 billion. And mortgage debt outstanding increased $35 billion between the second and third quarter to $8.13 trillion. They then show on a chart that the growth in the dollar amount of student loans outstanding has ultimately remained pretty constant over the past 5 years, but the trend in borrowing for those student loans, vehicles, and housing has climbed. According to the U.S. Census, there are 115 million American households in 2010. That means if we divide the total revolving credit outstanding by the number of households, that means the average family has $7,630 in revolving debt, meaning credit card debt. The U.S. Census also reports that in 2010, there were 234 million people over the age of 18, which suggests the average adult owes about $3,761 in revolving credit to lenders. Across the average household, adults also owe $11,000 in student loans, $8,000 on their autos, and $70,000 on their mortgage. But that $11,000 is way low, and that's because they're taking average household to determine student loans. But not the average household probably doesn't necessarily even have someone in it with a student loan. So right. I would say that student loan average, like if you looked at the average student loan and the average amount due on that student loan, it's probably tens of thousands of dollars.
You have people coming out with, you know, $70,000 in debt.
Right.
You know, between 20
common.
And 70. Yeah,
20 sounds like on the low end. Whenever we talk to people on this show about student loan debt, it's usually like 30 to 50 to 70 thousand, like at least 50. You know, typically 50,000 seems like sort of the.
Yeah, I actually. So I have quite a number of school credits under my belt. No degree, because I moved around a lot. But no, it got to the point where, and this is, you know, years ago, where the tuition was just going up $100 every year, you know, and for, you know, per credit, and it's like, no, I can't afford. I can't afford to finish my schooling. So, and it's not worth, and of course, by then I awakened to the idea that, hey, you know, what degree am I actually working for? Is this actually going to help me better in life? Is this actually going to help me get a job better? Or is my job experience? So when employers look at my credit, they're looking at my past jobs, and that's what they really care a whole lot more about.
According to the Kansas City Federal Reserve Bank, the average person carrying student loan debt owes $25,000. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What's your debt story? Free Talk Live.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
The new fourth edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the new Healing Our World is a great gift this Christmas for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, December 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,080 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $440. Antiwar.com reports coalition airstrikes against the major the Islamic State held Iraqi city of Mosul leveled homes in a residential neighborhood on Monday, killing at least 20 people, including at least 12 civilians. The claim was that the homes were used by the Islamic State. Witnesses said one of the houses belonged to the son of a local the Islamic State commander. Several other houses in the area were badly damaged by the attacks, and officials have conspicuously not commented on the incident so far. U.S. officials have generally not admitted to large civilian death tolls during airstrikes against the Islamic State territory, insisting the reports of eyewitnesses in those areas are not credible and refusing to investigate the claims more thoroughly. Mosul is the largest city of the Islamic State and has been held by the Islamic State since the summer of 2014. Though U.S. and Iraqi officials have talked up the eventual counterattack, there is no timetable for trying to reclaim the city, which is still deeply entrenched in the Islamic State's territory. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. UPI reports the U.S. Food and Drug Administration on Monday overturned a rule banning gay men from donating blood, but will still impose some restrictions. The FDA's lifetime ban on blood donations from gay and bisexual men that's been in effect for 32 years has been lifted, but a new policy will ban men from donating blood if they've had sex with another man in the previous year. The lifetime ban was put in place amid the AIDS crisis. The FDA said in a statement the decision was made to reflect the most current scientific evidence and to help ensure continued safety of the blood supply by reducing the risk of human immunodeficiency virus transmitted by blood and blood products. The FDA said it will continue to reevaluate blood donor deferral policies whenever new scientific information becomes available. Critics of the new policy have said that gay men are still effectively banned from donating blood because they must be abstaining from sex, but the agency said it does not have research to loosen the regulation any further than the 12-month ban. Among other groups subject to the same 12-month ban in order to reduce the risk of HIV and AIDS transmission includes heterosexuals who have used intravenous drugs or had sex with prostitutes in the previous 12 months.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a Baltimore police officer will face retrial on manslaughter charges over the death of Freddie Gray starting on June 13th, according to a Maryland judge on Monday after the officer's first trial ended in a deadlocked jury. The Maryland State Court's office said in a statement that Judge Barry Williams set the trial date after meeting prosecutors and defense lawyers. Gray's death in April caused protest in the city and intensified U.S. debate on police treatment of minorities. The date for the retrial of Officer William Porter in Baltimore Baltimore City Circuit Court could snarl prosecutors' strategy to use him as a key witness against other officers in the high-profile trial. Porter was the first of six officers to be tried in connection with Gray's death from a broken neck sustained while in police custody. A jury was unable to reach a decision last week, and Williams declared a mistrial. Porter faces charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, reckless endangerment, and misconduct in office. The trial of the van driver, Officer Caesar Goodson, who faces the most serious charge of second-degree depraved heart murder, is set to begin on January 6th. Prosecutors had hoped to convict Porter and use him as a witness against Goodson and Sergeant Alicia White. Porter testified he passed Gray's request for medical help to them, but none was summoned. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. Hager physicists have created quantum slacks. This is Doyle Redland reporting. The stunning announcement that a team of Hager physicists has successfully developed quantum slacks was made this morning at a press conference in Philadelphia. According to Dr. Daniel Chang, head of the Hager team, conventional notions about the physical properties and possibilities of slacks have been turned on their heads.
We are on the verge of unzipping the secrets of creation and peering into the pants of God himself. It appears the very fabric of the universe may well be a smart cotton twill weave.
However, Chang urged caution in further research after tests conducted last month at the Hager Pants Propulsion Collider Laboratory in Dallas suggested the possible existence of so-called anti-pants, which could, in theory, initiate a chain reaction resulting in no pants at all. Doyle Redlin for the Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We were talking about debt, but coming up, I definitely want to get into this IGN, was it? What was it? No, IGD? Internet Gaming Disorder? Conan?
It's not a clinical disorder yet, but you know that it's right around the corner.
Well, it's been put on the proposal list,
that's,
right?
That's the age we live in right now is the age of disorders, where everyone's got something. There's a reason why I'm afflicted with the problems that I have, Ian, is because of a disorder. And if I can get it clinically...
There's a pill for that, Conan.
There might be a pill. There might be some money involved. I might not have to work as hard at work. I can just say, hey, look, boss, IGD, you know? And I'm going to sue you now because Bethesda for taking my job away and my wife away from me.
Well, let's talk about that because that's in the news. But if you still want to talk about debt, you're welcome to. We were going over some of the numbers about Americans and their current amounts of debt. They're getting into more debt now that the supposed recession is supposedly over. Debt is increasing again in the United States.
But it's an investment, Ian. You know, if I want a better job down the road, I've got to invest all that time, energy, and money into education. It's gonna better me in the long run. I've got to buy that expensive old car to get me back and forth from work because, you know, I live too far away. I decided I'd live way out in the woods in that big old $300,000 home. And work at a restaurant.
Cars are rarely an investment, although if you do have to get from point A to point B, it's certainly nice to have one.
Well, my truck is most definitely an investment. It gets me from A to B, but I also truck a lot of stuff around in it. So
that's true.
I would say if you're getting from A to B, it's an investment. Now, how often are you using that car at ride to go joyriding, to just go driving around or go to an hour away to the local club?
It's a liability. I mean, a car is never going to give you a direct return, right? If you buy a car, it's going to be worth less when you sell it. If you buy a car new, it's going to be worth significantly less when you sell
it. Yeah, it's like $5,000 right off of it. As soon as you roll it off
the lot.
You just lost five.
So, I mean, looking at it from that perspective, it's by no means an investment, but if it's part of a tool, if it's a tool that you're using, then I could see that it could be useful there. And certainly, it's an investment to purchase a home, although those are also liabilities because then you're at very least your monthly payments are going to pay off your home as opposed to paying off your landlord's home, and so that it does benefit you in the long run to do that. But a little bit more here from Fool.com about Americans and their debts. According to the story, the New York Fed reports there are 410 million credit card accounts in America, which suggests the average balance on the average credit card in the average American's wallet is a $2,151 balance. Multiply that amount times the average number of credit cards, which is 3.7 credit cards, according to creditcards.com, that they estimate that each person has open, and the average American with a credit card owes $7,950 in revolving debt. According to the Kansas City Federal Reserve Bank, the average person carrying a student loan owes $25,000, and dividing total auto debt and mortgage debt by the total number of open accounts for those types of debt indicates the average American with those types of debt owes $10,000 on their car and $100,000 on their home, respectively. If your debt balances are higher than those averages, don't despair. There's plenty of time to make changes that could have significant impacts on your financial security down the road. People who have higher than average debt should consider doubling their monthly minimum payments or doing an extra monthly payment over the course of the year.
They could start with stop going to the movies and stop going to the restaurants every weekend.
That's an excellent point. They don't mention that here. This isn't an article that gets into detail about how to end your debt. But changing your habits is probably the most important thing that you can do. Stop doing the excessive spending. You eat out. That's a huge one. That right there. You go out to one restaurant, you're probably spending as much at that one restaurant as you would spend going to the grocery store to buy food for a week.
For a week.
Yeah. And so, being able to, I mean, even if you're buying prepared food from a grocery store, you're probably still doing better than going to a restaurant.
I'd say it's pretty close.
You think so?
Yeah. Working at Walmart for 6 years, I constantly seeing the price of some of these foods. Now, some of the cheapy 99-cent banquet meals, yeah, you could probably
the microwave food, yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, if you're just going ramen and rice and potatoes, I mean, you could. I mean, a 10-pound bag of potatoes, $3.
Nothing.
I mean, you can live. You said you can live a week off of the price of one restaurant meal.
I think that's true.
I think if you're just eating potatoes and rice, which might be hard for some people,
right?
And, I think you can go too easy.
So that's one thing. Cut your habits. If you can, if you've got a vice, eliminate it. I mean, it's worth it, right? Like if you're in debt,
you smoke,
you're
if you
smoking
drink,
cigarettes,
if you do any of this,
or you have a caffeine habit, because some people don't consider caffeine a vice. But look, if you're getting up in the morning, you got to have your coffee. If you got to go to Starbucks or whatever, look, if you must have coffee, at least brew it at your house. That way you're not spending $5 on a cup of it every single day.
We have three of those silly guys now.
What?
They just opened a new Starbucks right down from my house.
Oh, interesting. Three Starbucks in
and
Keene.
What is it? I've never even been in, and I probably will never be in a Starbucks or what's the other one? The competitor. It's always across the street from them.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Dunkin' Donuts. I mean, what does a cup of Joe cost at just
I
coffee?
I haven't the slightest clue.
What, $3?
I have no idea. I don't buy coffee.
Yeah, I mean, it's ridiculous.
I did go to Starbucks once in the last year, basically, and that was only because I wanted to try out a new Bitcoin app. There's the coffee, I think it's coffee.foldapp.com, F-O-L-D-A-P-P, coffee.foldapp.com. You can get 20% off of your Starbucks purchases by paying with Bitcoin. I just wanted to try it and see if it worked, and so I bought Renee a cup of coffee. I didn't even drink the coffee. Cut out your vices. And if you're a cigarette smoker and you're spending $5 a day on cigarettes, I think a lot of cigarette smokers smoke a pack to two packs a day. So if you're in New York City, that's $10 to $15 a pack. You're talking about a serious amount of money there that you're throwing down into your lungs. And that's money that could be used to pay off that credit card debt. So,
which by the way, is going to come back and haunt you, 20,
later
30
on,
years
down
from
the
now.
Line.
What do you care? Because healthcare is free, right? and that's what it really comes down to, my original point. People don't feel this. They don't feel that pain.
They don't have the incentives.
And when they do feel it, they're just going to complain to their local politician, and they're going to try to get the guys who are selling them their poison, try to get them. They're going to, like this guy who's suing the Fallout, the new Fallout game.
Yeah, I want to talk about that.
He has ruined his life. Bethesda made a nice game for us all to enjoy, and there's some clown out there who has gone to the lengths to ruin his own life. It's his own fault, and he is turning it back on the people who provided him this nice game.
He wants 500,000 rubles, which is about $7,000. He's a Siberian gamer suing the makers of Fallout 4, which is the new hot thing in the PC slash console gaming world. I've been playing it. It's a fantastic game. After he lost his job and broke up with his wife because, he says, of the video game. He wants $7,000 in U.S. dollars in compensation, saying he didn't know that the game would, quote, become so addictive, unquote. The 28-year-old man from Krasnoyarsk found out about the game in an advertisement and subsequently downloaded it onto his computer. That was when his problems began in earnest. According to RT.com, he only intended to play it for a couple of evenings, but instead became addicted, and the next 3 weeks flew by. Such was his dedication to the game, which sees the player emerge from a bunker following a devastating nuclear holocaust in a post-apocalyptic world that his own apocalypse unfolded right before his eyes. He regularly skipped work, which resulted in his employers firing him. He stopped meeting up and speaking with friends, and his wife left him. His health also started to deteriorate as he was not sleeping or eating. Statement from the man said this, quote, "If I knew that this game could have become so addictive, I would have become a lot more wary of it. I would not have bought it, or I would have left it until I was on holiday or until the New Year holidays," the statement read. The native of Krasnoyarsk now wants to sue Bethesda Game Studios and the Russian localization firm for the $7,000 in emotional distress.
If I see disclaimers on games, this warning, this game might steal your life, I'm going to be very annoyed. Because that's coming down the pipes, man.
855-450-FREE. You can tell us your gaming addiction story.
All right, listen up, because this is the most important thing you're going to hear all day. What if I said you could make money flipping houses without any cash, credit, or manual labor? And what if I said you could do it part-time from the comfort of your home? Sound unflippin' believable? Hi, I'm Preston Ealy, and I'm going to prove it by sending you a free copy of my smash hit-selling book, How to Get Rich in Real Estate. It sells online for $19.95, but I'm giving away 5,000 free copies this week. To get one before they're gone, call 1-800-961-8439. I used to be so broke, I had my electricity shut off 9 times, but I figured out a simple way to make money flipping houses without even breaking a sweat. Now I'm living the good life, and so should you. Listen, if you're sick and tired of stressing about money, this book could change your life. Hands down, it's the fastest, easiest way to get started in real estate. Let me prove it. Call right now to find out how to get your free book. When they're gone, they're gone. Call 1-800-961-8439. 1-800-961-8439.
Concerned about harmful contaminants in your water? Look to ProPure, the most trusted name in gravity water filtration systems. ProPure, with the silver-infused Pro-1 G2.0 filter, removes over 200 contaminants, including VOCs, heavy metals, chloramines, pesticides, pharmaceuticals, fluorides, and radiologicals. We don't just say it, we back it up. The Pro-1 G2.0 filter is NSF 42 certified and independently tested to meet NSF 53 and P231 standards. ProPure water, the way nature meant it to be. Clean, crisp, and refreshing. Purchase with confidence in quality, performance, and customer service. Take advantage of our biggest holiday 25% off sale going on now. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com. Or call 800-544-3533. 800-544-3533.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com, advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Conan.
And, of course, you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting for you there on the site. All of them are free, unlike those other talk show hosts who charge you for their sites. So go to freetalklive.com. One of the things we offer to you on our site is to save money on purchases at Amazon. Because you do have to buy things for life, even if you are trying to scrimp and save. Every now and then you got to buy something. So why not save 20%? Why not save 30%? You can decide to set your amount of savings at whatever amount that you want. Daryl was just telling me he got 50% off an item, actually a new cell phone through Amazon. If it's something you can wait for, set it a high percentage and just sit and wait and see what happens. SaveItPurse.com allows you to do this. The key is you have to use Bitcoin to get these amazing discounts on Amazon. I know it works. I've done it more than 24 times myself this year alone. So please go to SaveItPurse.com. When you sign up through that link, Free Talk Live will get a portion, a small portion, of your future purchases. Save A-T Purse. SaveAtPurse.com. As we go to your phone calls and thoughts, more about video game addiction. There's now a disorder that may be being added to the DSM. I don't think it has been yet, but it has been proposed to be added to the DSM, as I understand it. Internet Gaming Disorder, IGD. Is that right, Conan?
Correct.
So we'll talk more about that, but want to hear your stories as well about gaming addiction. One guy in Russia, in Siberia specifically, is suing Bethesda Softworks for the Fallout 4 game, claiming that he has lost his wife and that he's lost his job as a result of playing Fallout 4. Well, I believe that he has lost his wife and his job. I mean, but that's not an uncommon story.
After 3 weeks,
seems pretty ridiculous that she'd leave in that short a time. It's probably things were going bad before three weeks.
Yes, yes. He sounds like a bad apple. And anyone who anybody who would go to the lengths that this guy is to sue an entity like this because of a sin. It's a syntax kind of a thing. But yeah, he's gone to certain lengths that make me think that he already has issues.
No doubt about it. And obviously somebody who is on the rocks with their significant other generally, who all of a sudden starts paying no attention to that person, isn't cleaning up after themselves.
And his job. He probably wasn't doing well at his job either.
Yeah, so. And has become a significant burden. Well, in this case, he just wasn't showing up.
Mm-hmm.
And this isn't uncommon. I mean, we've talked about gaming addiction over the years here on Free Talk Live, and every now and then you'll hear stories like this. Now, the suing part is what's unusual about his story. But to have someone lose a job or a girlfriend or wife over being addicted to a video game, that's a story that has been told a number of times. So maybe it's happened to you, or maybe you came close. Let's go to Tim listening in Wyoming. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Conan.
Hey guys.
Hey there.
Thanks for taking my call.
Yes,
years ago I had a, well, this is like I say, years ago. I had a PlayStation 1, first version, obviously. I had a video game that, I played it so many times and for so many hours, I actually called the developers and I told them that I'd done certain things. They said that it's impossible that you played it and beat it in that many hours because it's designed to be X number of hours. And they said I beat it in like 10 hours early. But somehow, I mean, I just played it over and over and over again. And it's really a good way to waste time if you really think about it.
They sure are.
Yes, it's an escape for real.
Yeah, I mean, video games are a way to pass as much time as possible till something else important happens.
But some people turn it into a job. I mean, it really does become an activity that encapsulates their entire life.
So what was the game, Tim? I'm curious. PlayStation
1.
We're going way back here.
PlayStation 1. Yeah, way back. Yeah, it was called, Shadow Man.
Never heard of it.
You could actually play looking through the person's eyes, or you could play with the person in the distance and then in the far distance. And then you could play with the person facing you, which is almost impossible because you'd never get anywhere. You don't know what you're looking at. But the thing was, they said, the developers said something like, they said it was something like 36 hours or some odd thing, some hours like that. And I think I played it in 22 or 23 hours.
So what were the consequences for you? And by the way, I did just look it up, and I recognize the box art. I just didn't recognize the name.
It was a fun game. I mean,
what were the consequences for you?
Well, I'd say the consequences were basically that I used it as a drug, if you want to call it that. I said, well, this is my escape from reality, as Conan said a minute ago. He said something about that it's an escape from reality. That's what people do with drugs and alcohol and whatever else. I mean, sex addiction and various other things. I mean, some people buy video games that are actually sex games, too. I mean, I'm sure you can do that, but you can do it online.
Oh, yeah, if I can get a game that's sex, getting my nicotine and my alcohol buzz, and I get to kill monsters, I get to shoot Nazis, woo!
Well, they don't have that yet, but it could be coming.
Well, I mean, if you're able to, what would the... globalist Nazi, let's say globo Nazi alien, anti-globo Nazi alien game or something like that.
So, I mean, did you lose a job or anything like that? It was just an addiction, something you did on a regular basis.
I'd say, yeah, I lost the will to do something more exciting. More exciting as in, you know, something like get up off of the couch and go, go do something productive, so to speak. I mean, actually, when Conan said something about turning it into a job, there are a lot of people that do that. When I called, like I said, when I called the developers and I asked them, I said, I did this game in this certain amount of time, and the guy was astonished. He said, are you a beta tester or something like that? I said, no. I said, no, I don't. I said, what's that? I said, I'd never heard of the term, of course, but He said, nobody's ever played that game so fast. How did you do that? I said, I don't know.
Well, you'd probably love the speed runs they do on the internet. There are these gaming, like, obsessees who...
You guys can beat Mario Brothers in, like, 3 minutes or something.
Yeah, who can just run through a game in record time. Tim, thanks for calling, sharing your story tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I mean, I can relate. I definitely play when I get into playing a game, and it's not often that I do, but when I do, I'll play it like a crack addict, man. I'm up all night. It's 6 in the morning, 7 in the morning sometimes before I finally, okay, the sun's coming up. I probably should go to sleep now. And Fallout's one of those games. Fallout.
I can do that. I'm not as bad. In fact, the last game you asked me that I was playing, I'm still playing.
Which game is that?
Styx. It's a sneaky thief game.
Ah, okay.
Would you ask me like 2 months ago? Mm. Of course, I found another casual game to play. It's one of those Gems games, but it's
one of those pickup games.
Gems of War, so it's not just Bejeweled, but it's you actually level up your characters and whatnot. So you've got that hooked aspect. And anytime you get these games where you have to level up and get the next best card, and you've got to save up this many points to get the new sword or whatnot, Those are the good ones, man. They really, and that's what this Chinese program is all about. It's all about the point system and rewarding you. You get better things with your points. You can get the nice job, or you can get the date, because they're actually using the points and putting it on their dating profile.
If you want to join us here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. What's your worst gaming addiction story? And has there ever been a time when gaming's actually done something for you, like won you a prize or something? It's Free Talk Live.
As the cold and flu season approaches, Silver Lungs is ready to help you and your family through the toughest of the year by supporting your immune system and overall health. From our best-selling colloidal silver generating system to our entire line of silver-based skin gels, nasal sprays, soaps, and silver solutions, Silver Solutions remain one of nature's most powerful and least expensive antibacterial agents. Now you can produce your own for pennies a day in the comfort of your home using the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. Learn more today at www.silverlungs.com.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty HealthShare.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live. Are you addicted to video games or to one video game in specific? And has it affected your life? Maybe not today. Maybe you were addicted in the past. You want to tell us your story about what happened to you? Now, it's not the video game's fault for being super good and entertaining and fun. It's your fault. Unfortunately, this guy in Russia, who's now suing Bethesda Software or Softworks, is—he's saying it's Bethesda's fault for making such an addictive game, and he ultimately lost his wife and lost his job, among other things, because he was playing the game constantly and not sleeping, apparently, or eating. His health started to deteriorate, according to RT.com. So, if you want to tell your story to us about your video game addiction, or maybe someone you love, or you know, an ex-boyfriend or girlfriend, and you want to tell that story, please.
Someone you kicked to the curb because they couldn't handle their addiction.
Or did you get them help and you managed to break the problem? The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's go and to the phones and the fun. You can bring up anything you want here. Robert is on the line in Vermont. Go ahead, Robert.
Hi, guys. Hey, I hear you talking about addiction. And I kind of want to share a little bit about myself because I have an issue and I've tried to address it and I'm trying to get past it and it's just not working for me. Mm-hmm. It's an eating addiction. Mm-hmm. And I've been desperately trying to lose weight because I have a disease that's stuffing me right out. I have peripheral neuropathy. I've lost a lot of feeling in my legs and in my back and stuff. And one of the things that the doctor wants me to do is to try to lose weight. Mm. And I understand the concept behind your wanting to try to lose weight. It's a discipline thing. It's knowing when to eat, how much to eat, what not to eat. And it's a real daunting task. And I'm finding it very difficult for me to, you know, apply this to, you know, my life.
Let me ask you one question. Do you admit that you have a problem?
Yes.
Okay, so there's first step right there. I guess the other one is, the next step is just filling that void, or it's not a void yet, but it's going to be a void when you're not, you know, eating, filling it with something else. And I guess the question is what do you do? I mean, do you have enough activities in your life to keep you fulfilled?
At one point in my life, I'm at fault here because I let myself go. Okay, mm-hmm. See, one thing that you're not aware of, Colin, is that Keen and I, we know each other. I've been over to the church, and so he knows. You know, that I'm a pretty good sized guy.
You're a big boy, no doubt. Is that picture? I've seen you on your Facebook profile, Robert. I've seen a picture of like some badass biker guy from way back. Was that you?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yes, you've definitely had quite a change.
At one point I was up to like almost 450 pounds because I let myself go. I smoked and I ate too much and I drank and I couldn't. I was having a hard time just walking from my house out to the mailbox. It was so bad. But I mean, I've since long made some change. Like I haven't smoked in 3.5 years.
That's good. That's a win.
I threw them away. I stopped. You know, just
obviously you can't stop eating because then you'll starve. But yeah, I mean, it's a tricky thing to do. And I wish Daryl were on the show tonight because he has, I think. He has lost over 130 pounds, I believe, in the last year, basically, from essentially doing a combo of a couple things. He stopped eating like breads, I guess, and he's restricted what he eats. He's doing, I think, the low carb or no carb. I'm not sure. Again, he's not here to answer the question, so he would be better at explaining this than I am. So he's adjusted what he eats. He's adjusted the quantity of what he eats as well. So the other day we went out to this Bitcoin meetup and he ordered a chicken sandwich, but there was he did not want any bread on that chicken sandwich, nor did he want really pretty much anything else on the chicken sandwich. So he got basically a chicken patty.
Well, he would have wanted to have it grilled.
Yeah, I don't know if it was grilled or not, but you know, he's been really careful with this. He's been eating yogurt instead of some of the things that he would snack on before. And so he made some real specific changes and has stuck to them. And in addition, has started going to the gym as well. So the combo of those two things.
And very importantly, he is a very busy man. So he is busy doing other things. He's not just laying around on the couch.
That's true.
That's when people... hey, you know what? Another video game, another couple of minutes,
feeling
or another
themselves.
Bag of Doritos, and that's not feeling sorry for themselves. It's just idle hands doing the devil's work.
Well, that's true.
And you know, and it's not just Daryl either. It's also co-host James Cleveland who took off a bunch of pounds, and he did the same exact thing. It's all about the calorie, or not the calories. It's a little bit about calories, but it's a lot about the carbs. And he just took it right off.
Cut out the carbs, right. Cut out the soda or anything like that. If you're drinking sugary drinks or anything like that.
I don't drink any. I mean, I know what not to eat. Like, I mean, my first I don't eat anything that's out of a can at all. Mm-hmm. You know, and I've just worked my way out to where, I mean, I live, you know, where I live, Ian. I'm able to walk all the way down to Bellas Falls. And then walk all the way back, which is a pretty decent height.
So you've seen some improvement then.
I'll go and I'll take the bus and I'll go down to Brattleboro and I'll walk around town down there. But I mean, I'm able to keep going and stuff like that. But I'm just, I don't know. It's like I'm not satisfied.
Hmm. You have to fill that void with something else. That's all I know. And you know what? You're talking to Ian and Conan. I mean, we're
skin and bones.
We're skin and bones already. So I don't know that we're the right guys to be talking about this particular addiction.
There's got to be some kind of support group that you can get involved with that could, you know, maybe make some suggestions and maybe reach out to Daryl and ask him exactly what his his approach was. And Robert, good luck. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Gamma Blast is on the line in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live. Gamma Blast.
Hey, guys. I'm thinking that wearing that crown all the time gave Mark a real king complex for real.
Yeah, Mark, former co-host of Free Talk Live, who resigned this weekend in frustration mm-hmm. over what he perceives of not enough support in the Liberty community. Saying that he will not be coming back until the Free Talk Live AMP program reaches $5,000 per month, which he doesn't benefit from.
But he's acting like a king. He's like, I hereby declare all my loyal subjects, you must raise me $5,000 henceforth.
Well, he doesn't. Technically,
my command before I return.
Well, technically, the money isn't going to Mark. It's going to the AMP program, which he doesn't have any control over. So, you know, if he had been saying he was going to leave unless people gave him money specifically, that would have been really pretty bad and indefensible, I think. But the opinions of listeners on this have, of course, varied widely. Some people think that Mark was whiny in his delivery of his message on Saturday night. Others definitely it rung
a bit diva, to say the least.
Others it rang true for them. It rang as honest that this was what, you know, Mark feels is important. This is how he measures his importance in the world. I don't agree with him. I don't measure my importance in that way at all. I just appreciate everything that everyone contributes to the show, whether it's time sitting in here or it's just a few bucks a month or whatever. Gosh, I'm so grateful for it because to me, you know, that's just where I come from on this. And you know, Mark and I are not the same person. Maybe he'll come back someday. Maybe not.
You know, I just made a very similar decision in my life, and I was, you know, I had a podcast for two and a half years.
Black Sheep Rising.
And I decided that it was time to go on hiatus, and you know, the viewership was down, and it was taking a lot out of me. I wasn't making any money off of it.
Mm-hmm.
I make a few donations here and there.
Well, Mark's
I understand his point completely. I see both sides too. Some saying he's a little whiny about all this, but some other people are mentioning that he's a really good half of Ian. And I'm wondering how it's gonna look. The future of
Free
FTL
Talk
is
Live
look.
Has existed without Mark in the past, and it will be fine without him in the future. The toll free number tonight. Thank you, Gamma Blast, for the call. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And he's not gone. He's still working behind the scenes doing sales for the mm-hmm. show.
I was coming out of the hardware store when I saw him. An old man, late 70s, hunched over in the freezing rain, no hat on his head, limping across that slippery parking lot, and pushing a row of shopping carts toward the cart corral. It's heartbreaking. Millions of hardworking Americans simply don't have enough money to retire, So they just keep working and working and working until it's too late. Hi, I'm Chad Stubbs, president and CEO of PowerTrader, and I believe that's just plain wrong. That's why I'm now distributing to the public absolutely free copies of PowerTrader's game-changing book on how regular folks can make the money they need to retire fast. For your free copy, call 1-800-771-6706. Don't let the lack of money rob you of your retirement. Call now for details and get your free copy of this book before it's too late. 1-800-771-6706. But hurry while supplies last. 1-800-771-6706. 1-800-771-6706.
You haven't experienced yogurt until you've tried Amasi, embodying health and flavor in a true whole milk, green-fed dairy beverage. Every sip pays homage to our old-world cows and the ancient culturing methods their milk benefits from. With over 30 probiotics, Amasi's undeniably nutritious, refined, cultured sensation bolsters your health and awakens your passion for dairy. Amasi's so good, and you need to try it. Contact your Youngevity distributor or call 877-878-4203 or go to gcnteam.com.
Ted Anderson telling you about Jordan Rubin's Beyond Organic Green-Fed Raw Cheddar Artesian Cheese featuring whole milk created through ancient dairy breeding. Unpasteurized, untreated whole milk on the same farm the cows graze. Containing natural sources of omega-3s, CLA protein, calcium, probiotics, and enzymes. I have never tasted cheese this good, and you need to try it. Contact your Youngevity distributor or call 877-878-4203 or go to gcnteam.com.
Because we are smothering in spam, please do not reply to all when you can instead reply. I was recently among over 100 invited to a corporate reunion. It's always a warm affair, and that's the problem. Enthusiasm for our upcoming get-together caused many recipients to RSVP the organizer with a cheery reply to all. I can't wait. Then others piled on with a reply to all to that. Then the I'm out of my office now autoresponders joined in. So I replied to all, asking that we all reply only to the organizer. Hey, at least I tried. One invitee, apparently retired, shot back, point taken, but I really like seeing the responses since they're so positive. Smiley face. This better be an open bar. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts and Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. What is your video game addiction story? You want to tell it to us? Dial in toll-free. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We haven't even gotten into your story, Conan, about this internet gaming disorder that has been proposed as a new disorder to the long and ever-growing list of disorders. What is a normal person anyway? Apparently, everybody's got some sort of disorder.
Just a grouping of disorders,
yeah,
tied to another disorder.
So we're going to get a little bit deeper into that here, but if you want to share your story, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype username is lrn.fm. And we were just a moment ago, I think Gamma Blast had called in to give his thoughts on Mark leaving the show.
Yeah, and this is new to me. I kind of saw the tidbits, and so
when did
this
you
is,
hear about it?
I think I actually found out through Cantwell, because as soon as he found out, he wrote an entire blog on it talking about this and that. And he, I guess to prove that, I don't know, he's Cantwell.
Yep. he's proven that.
He proves it time and time again. So yeah, that was pretty much, that was the beginning of it. And so I don't know the story behind it. I don't know the numbers, you know, how much the donations, how much donations are coming in and not, and how many not donations are not coming in. So this, well, this is all news to me.
He's frustrated. I'm going to try to encapsulate it for you here, Conan. There's a clip on our SoundCloud page that is about a 10-minute long segment of our Saturday night show. It's the last segment of our Saturday night show where Mark explains his reasons for leaving the airwaves. And basically it's this. He feels as though that the level of support for Free Talk Live should be higher. He feels as though of, let's say, 2,500 to 4,000 downloads per day, he feels that should result in a higher number of people giving to the show's AMP program, the AMP program being a $5 a month program that allows us to market Free Talk Live to radio stations and expand our coverage on satellite and in the internet as well. And I've always just looked at the AMP program as, wow, that's great that that's coming in, because it's more than what we've had. You know, it's more, if it's more than zero, it's great in my book. And I think we've got about 270 or so amplifiers. So I see that as about 10% or maybe a little less than 10% of the total number of downloads that we'll get from the program. And I consider 10% to be pretty darn good. Like, I think that's decent. I guess it's not good to him. I guess he feels like in order to feel valuable to the world that he needs to be validated by other people giving money to the show, which, by the way, again, doesn't go to his paycheck. It goes to pay Daryl to do affiliate relations for us and some other things as well. If you go to amp.freetalklive.com, there's kind of a rundown of some of the things that the money goes to there. And so it's designed to help Free Talk Live spread the message of liberty. And I guess he just feels like, you know, we should have more of that coming in.
Do you think he might just be wanting to take a break? You said in that this has actually happened before.
He takes a break every year this time. He leaves for Florida. He goes down for a month. So this coincides with him taking that break. And I'm sure he'd love to see, you know, a bunch of AMP contributions total up more than $5,000 so he can come back. That's what he said. That was the number, the arbitrary number that he selected. And so I don't know if it's going to do that. The AMP program has been hovering around $3,000 for the last 4 years or something like that.
Right.
So there really hasn't been any growth whatsoever over time. The last couple days, though, there really has been an explosion in AMP growth. It's gone up a few hundred, if not several hundred dollars.
So just to let the viewers know, listeners, this is not a FTL conspiracy to get more AMP subscribers.
What do you mean when you say it's a conspiracy? No, it's not being planned in secret. Mark is openly explaining what he's doing.
Well, alternative motives behind his leaving the show.
I'm not sure I understand what you're saying.
In order to get those AMP subscribers that he was talking about, that he was whining
he's
about.
He's hoping this will motivate people to AMP the show.
So not a conspiracy in a way. So he is it's his hopes that this will bring more people on.
And it appears to have worked.
For just temporarily. I mean, if he's not on the show, if he's not on the show any longer to harp on this problem, then no one else is going to, unless you start,
I'm not going to come at it from the same perspective as he is, because I don't agree with him. But there are people out there who heard him leaving and thought, oh, crap, I guess I should probably AMP the show. And I think that that's one of the things he was trying to do with this, was to sort of poke people who've been out there listening for a long time. There was like a guy who sent an email today, and I'm way behind on the AMP emails. Normally, I only do them once a week. I'm trying to do them once a day now because there's so many coming in.
Right.
One guy said that he'd been listening for a decade and had never gotten around to it. Right. So Mark leaving the show was all of a sudden sort of a jab in the ribs for that guy, so to speak. Like, hey, you know, maybe you should do this now. So from that perspective, Mark was correct. Like, we've only had a couple people cancel their AMPs, but we've had literally dozens of people sign up within the last 48 to 72 hours. So it's been a record-setting last few days for the AMP program. I'm getting as many emails in for AMP in one day as I normally do in a week's time. So it's definitely worked from that perspective. Whether it'll get to $5,000, you know, it's likely going to peter off over time as far as how many people are signing up. Whether it's going to reach 5,000, I don't know.
The one thing that I did see in Cantwell's article was that that hit home. The fact that you guys are selling advertisements,
yep,
and you know, requesting subscriber donations.
Yeah, that's right.
And how many programs out there do that? How many are doing advertisements and donations?
Almost every nationally syndicated radio show.
Whereas some are just doing advertisements and nothing else, and then some are just doing donations.
Almost every national show has some web thing that they have, right? Like, it's not pitched as a donation. It's pitched as Rush 24/7. Yeah, and, give us $8 a month, and you'll have access to the webcam.
Right,
you'll
have
access to this. You'll have access to whatever. We give all that stuff away. So we have the webcam. We have the archives. We have all that stuff, and it's all free. So we can't just give people access to things they already have access to. So from that perspective, the idea was, well, the AMP program will help us build Free Talk Live, help us spread the ideas of freedom onto to radio stations.
And by the way, the information that is given on the show is not necessarily something you would want people to pay for, because it's because we're talking about people who might be waking up to the ideas of freedom,
right? We
libertarianism,
want it to get
voluntarianism,
out there.
and to charge people right off the bat, it's not going to be the way to do it,
right? Yeah, absolutely.
And in fact, libertarian podcasts in general are all of that mindset, because you know no one would ever listen.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. And let's see, there was one other thing I wanted to add in there regarding the other subscription services of these other shows. Those are going to pay the overhead for the administrative costs of staffing and whatever else. We don't really have staff with Free Talk Live.
You got Jazzy the studio dog.
Yeah, I do some of the affiliate relations. Daryl does affiliate relations more than I do these days, but I sort of run the show from a programming side, and Mark does the sales side of things. So when Mark sells ads, he does benefit from that, and that helps put food on his family's table, basically. So that's where that comes from. And Mark has left the show in the past. For those listeners who have not been around forever, because you would have had to have been listening in the very early days of Free Talk Live to know this, but in 2003, we started the show in late 2002. In 2003, relatively early in the year, Mark left Free Talk Live. So he was on in the very first episode back in late 2002, but was fired from Clear Channel in 2003. And when he was fired from Clear Channel, he was basically asked to not continue doing the show. Mm-hmm. And so he had to stop at that time. Later on, he came back on a weekly basis, so like a one day a week. And so like in 2004, he was on, I think it was Thursday nights was when Mark was on. And then ultimately, when the show got syndicated, he saw that it could possibly be something that could be a career for him, you know, that he might be able to transition as to the idea of selling Free Talk Live. And so he started working on that. And it was, I think, in late 2004 when he came back to the show on a full-time basis. So there was probably a good solid year where Mark was not on the show on a regular basis. First of all, he was not on at all for several months. And then when he came back, he was on a once a week basis. So it's really not the first time he's left. He's just, the last time he's been on was a really long run. He was on for a full decade,
right,
of his life. So that's a lot of that's a lot of dedication, and I appreciate him for that. And I appreciate him, you know, being here six nights a week to handle his role in the show. And he did bring a lot, to the table. He's a talented guy and well read and intelligent. And certainly, I'll miss having him here, but that doesn't mean...
And he's got that vein in his forehead.
And he can get very angry. That's certainly true.
I hope that the people who have come to rely on Mark, because he most definitely has his fans.
And he has his detractors.
Yeah, exactly. And so what are you going to do?
Everybody does.
I hope that those individuals are able to get past it and keep on listening. And, we'll see what happens.
That's true. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The mission of Free Talk Live continues in his on-air absence. Hour number three is on the way. Video game addiction. We'll continue with that.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please, join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, December 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,080 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $440. Antiwar.com reports coalition airstrikes against the major the Islamic State held Iraqi city of Mosul leveled homes in a residential neighborhood on Monday, killing at least 20 people, including at least 12 civilians. The claim was that the homes were used by the Islamic State. Witnesses said one of the houses belonged to the son of a local the Islamic State commander. Several other houses in the area were badly damaged by the attacks, and officials have conspicuously not commented on the incident so far. U.S. officials have generally not admitted to large civilian death tolls during airstrikes against the Islamic State territory, insisting the reports of eyewitnesses in those areas are not credible and refusing to investigate the claims more thoroughly. Mosul is the largest city of the Islamic State and has been held by the Islamic State since the summer of 2014. Though U.S. and Iraqi officials have talked up the eventual counterattack, there is no timetable for trying to reclaim the city, which is still deeply entrenched in the Islamic State's territory. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. UPI reports the U.S. Food and Drug Administration on Monday overturned a rule banning gay men from donating blood, but will still impose some restrictions. The FDA's lifetime ban on blood donations from gay and bisexual men that's been in effect for 32 years has been lifted, but a new policy will ban men from donating blood if they've had sex with another man in the previous year. The lifetime ban was put in place amid the AIDS crisis. The FDA said in a statement the decision was made to reflect the most current scientific evidence and to help ensure continued safety of the blood supply by reducing the risk of human immunodeficiency virus transmitted by blood and blood products. The FDA said it will continue to reevaluate blood donor deferral policies whenever new scientific information becomes available. Critics of the new policy have said that gay men are still effectively banned from donating blood because they must be abstaining from sex, but the agency said it does not have research to loosen the regulation any further than the 12-month ban. among other groups subject to the same 12-month ban in order to reduce the risk of HIV and AIDS transmission, includes heterosexuals who have used intravenous drugs or had sex with prostitutes in the previous 12 months.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a Baltimore police officer will face retrial on manslaughter charges over the death of Freddie Gray starting on June 13th, according to a Maryland judge on Monday after the officer's first trial ended in a deadlocked jury. The Maryland State Court's office said in a statement that Judge Barry Williams set the trial date after meeting prosecutors and defense lawyers. Gray's death in April caused protest in the city and intensified U.S. debate on police treatment of minorities. The date for the retrial of Officer William Porter in Baltimore City Circuit Court could snarl prosecutors' strategy to use him as a key witness against other officers in the high-profile trial. Porter was the first of six officers to be tried in connection with Gray's death from a broken neck sustained while in police custody. A jury was unable to reach a decision last week, and Williams declared a mistrial. Porter faces charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, reckless endangerment, and misconduct in office. The trial of the van driver, Officer Caesar Goodson, who faces the most serious charge of second-degree depraved heart murder, is set to begin on January 6th. Prosecutors had hoped to convict Porter and use him as a witness against Goodson and Sergeant Alicia White. Porter testified he passed Gray's request for medical help to them, but none was summoned. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Right now, it's looking like tonight's record $500 million Powerball drawing could be canceled, as embarrassed lottery officials have admitted they lost the balls. Douglas Braunstein, deputy director of the Multi-State Lottery Association, addressed the press moments ago. We have a quote. We know how important the balls are to a successful drawing. I saw them the other day, and I'm sure they'll turn up somewhere. Braunstein says it's usually marketing director Ben Callahan's job to keep an eye on the balls, but when reached for comment, Callahan said he just sits next to the balls. It's not his job to know where they are every second of every day. According to Braunstein, it's crucial they find the balls before tonight's drawing. Quote, we'd love to use different balls, but these ones have the numbers on them. Braunstein added that once they figure out where the balls are, they promise to keep them in some sort of case instead of just lying around the office. When we return, we'll meet some of the undeterred Powerball superfans who are camping out before the big drawing dressed as their favorite numbers.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Tell us your gaming addiction story. How has your fanaticism for video games affected your life? Some people, they lose their job. Some people, they lose their girlfriend or their wife. And you normally
some people just don't get anything done.
That's true as well. Some people, all three. Sometimes their house gets dirty, they don't sleep, they don't eat, they lose their wife, and they lose their job.
Some people actually start a Twitch channel, and they broadcast their video game playing
and make
while,
money from
while
it.
Doing commentary, doing playthroughs, or what would you call them, Ian?
On YouTube, they're called Let's Play.
Let's Play. Yeah, and some of them are really good at it. Some of them are very entertaining. So it's like, I want to see what this new video game looks like. So you can watch the review, or not the review, but sometimes
the experience.
The trailer that's been given to you.
Yeah.
Or you can watch some clown actually playing it, doing some hilarious sometimes commentary to go along with it. And maybe
and the reactions.
And maybe he'll get some subscribers, donations from people, and he can actually do it for a living.
It happens.
It happens. I would say probably don't... plan on that actually being happening because these people are really good at
it. Well, right, because there are a bunch of people doing this now. So
yeah, there's a lot of competition.
I learned about a character named PewDiePie.
Oh, yeah.
Casey, you familiar with him? He is on YouTube. Maybe he's got a Twitch channel, too. You just told me about this Twitch thing tonight. I hadn't heard about it before. So it's apparently a gaming-only video streaming service.
It is like a gaming, a video gaming YouTube service, and it's live. So, I mean, they have
it's all live.
Well, they have some archives available, but they are not focusing. I don't believe they're focusing on the archive aspect. They're focusing on the live experience.
This is what's happening now. People are playing these games. But on YouTube, they do have some YouTube live, but obviously most of YouTube is recorded. And this PewDiePie guy is, I guess, the most popular of all of the video game player people who, you know, basically, for those that aren't familiar with this, the video content is mostly the game, like a screen of mostly what you would see on the game screen. And then there's a little insert, sort of picture-in-picture style of the guy who's playing. And, you know, he's got a pair of headphones on. He's got a microphone mic'd up. And if they're
really good, and not all the players do this. They had the little insert on the one of the corners. They hide them, you know, outside of the HUD, so you're not covering up something important, something vital.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
The really good ones will have the green screen behind them, and they'll have that cut out, so all you see is the gamer with the headphones.
Oh,
and,
yeah,
you know,
that's fancy.
And you know, some of these guys are really good. I investigated a couple of months ago to see what was going on. I had never been on. I had some buddies at my previous workplace who did it and were investigating it themselves. And you know, some of these guys you can actually see and monitor the donations that are coming in. And they're,
really?
Yeah, it's some of these guys are really good.
And so I know that obviously the ones on YouTube, some of them are making money. Apparently, this PewDiePie guy makes a buku bucks off of this now. And I mean, I've seen some of his work. He's okay. I mean, I guess he's kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
And so some people bring different, I guess, elements to the table than others. And I guess the real experience there is that people get to watch a game being played, and that's a big thing these days, is watching somebody else playing video games.
I know. I try to wrap my brain around it, and I'm not the kind of guy who could actually sit and watch someone else playing.
I don't mind.
And this just isn't video games. This is sports. This is activities, all mm-hmm. activities. To sit there in the bleachers and watch someone else playing, unless I'm trying to figure out some secret that I couldn't figure it out on my own. It's like, all right,
how do you do it?
Some clown has already figured this out, so I'm watching the playthrough, and it's like, all right, that's how he did it.
Right.
And then I'm going right back to doing it myself. But to sit in the bleachers and watch people playing the sport or playing a video game or doing anything, it's like, man, I want to be out there. I can't stand just sitting here twiddling my thumbs.
I would probably have felt that way when initially, like if someone had initially told me about Let's Play, these kind of videos, I probably would have said the same things that you're saying,
mm-hmm.
but it really doesn't bother me that much. In fact, I actually kind of like it to watch someone else play a game, because then I feel like I don't have to bother.
Well, no, good point. And I just brought that up because I don't have Fallout 4.
Yeah.
You do. What did I do to satiate my desire to play Fallout 4?
I watched some
videos of some knuckleheads playing.
So you're
playing.
Guilty of it then. Well, I got it
out of my system real quick, especially when I realized that, you know what, this is Fallout 3. It's just prettier.
It is.
And you know what?
Pretty much
I can wait. I got enough games that I can play between here and between when Fallout 4 is on sale.
Well, one of the things about Fallout, a game like that, for listeners who aren't familiar, it's this first-person perspective, although you can play in third-person. It's mostly a first-person shooter kind of game, but it's an RPG at the same time, role-playing game, meaning that you are leveling up, as they call it in the video game world.
That's the hook.
You're gathering experience by killing the bad guys, and then the more experience you have, the more levels that you get, the more powerful your character becomes. Of course, on the other side, you're also encountering more powerful enemies, so ultimately it's just something that, you know, it's a cool game mechanic that it's not your typical shooter. In fact, you could argue that it's not a shooter at all.
I would say it's becoming the typical type shooter. I think a lot of people are leaning in this direction. A lot of game producers are leaning in this
direction. Anyway, with what I was going to say, though, about it is I don't think it's as good for one of these Let's Plays because there's a bunch of different things you can do in the game. So, like, in a game where there's pretty much one path you can take, you can watch one of these Let's Play videos and see the whole game. But with Fallout 4, there's different choices.
There might be five different options or dialogue options to one statement. And each one of them could take you down a different pathway.
Generally in the game, though, the dialogue options don't really change that much. It's just sort of the first few lines of dialogue will change, and then they'll sort of get you back on track with wherever the story's supposed to be going. So it sort of gives you an illusion of having choice, but
and that you bring this up, and we're actually talking about the different character types who are playing these games. I watched one where the guy was, every time you get to a dialogue, he'd be like, all right, audience, what do you think I should do?
Really?
And the audience would say, A, B, C, and he would actually do a real quick tally.
Yeah.
And he would say, all right, we're doing C. Everyone agreed C. And so, and that's the path he would take. So it was becoming a viewer. They were able to interact and actually be a part of this experience. So I think he was on track. He was doing the right, he was making the right decision.
That reminds me, I've seen one of these live video things. Most of the video game footage I've seen online is recorded, but I have seen a few channels doing it live. And when I see that, they have the little chat room on YouTube, and the chat is just burning by, like message after message. You couldn't possibly read what everything was saying.
Yeah, you have 5,000-plus viewers. There's no way.
Right. And so, like, there's a certain point of saturation at which the chat room becomes useless, because then all you could really do is just sort of glance at it, take the first response that you see and go with that, because otherwise it'd be impossible to get a real temperature for what's going on there.
Yeah.
I mean, the same thing's true of any chat room. Once there's too many chatters in there, it just becomes noise, and it's hard to figure out what the signal is.
Twitch has, if I understand correctly, they actually have, like, they have chat monitors.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're going to have little cues where if someone donates, you can have a little bell go off or something. And so that the player will know that he just had a donation and he can respond immediately. But you can also have chat moderators who are actually going through and picking out choice information and relaying it to the player.
So part of the fun of the watching people play games online, Conan, is the reactions. So I think that the ones that are the most boring videos are the ones where you're just watching someone play a video game.
Without any commentary or anything like that. A picture of them or anything. I agree.
But if you can see the picture of the person and they're mic'd up and they're reacting, they fell in a hole and their eyes light up, they're shouting or yelling at the guy or whatever. That's what makes it more entertaining. And that's why someone like a PewDiePie is so popular, because he has these reactions. Now, whether he's playing up the reactions because he knows they're popular is another question. And, you can debate about that. But there's what got me kind of into it a little bit was the React channel, which is a really, I think, a fun channel on YouTube, where they have different age people. So they have like seniors or elders react. They have kids react. They have teens react. They now have an adults react series. So they have all these different series. And so sometimes they'll react to like a viral video or something like that, something that's online and has become popular. And they also have a gaming series, which the elders ones are hilarious.
Are these the same guys who are videotaping cops and old women smoking pot? Or is this a whole different crew?
They do have a YouTubers React where some of the YouTube pranksters are on that, but no. The React channel is mostly people you've never seen before. These are like just average folks from California.
Watching like up-to-date video games for the first time. And
playing video games.
Grand Theft 5.
In the elders case, it's for the first time. In the teens case, many of them have played the games before.
Oh, I did watch one. I watched millennials playing GoldenEye.
Yep, that was one of them. Yeah. Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You want a good laugh, though? Watch any of the elders react to video games. It's so funny, because they just don't know what they're doing. It's Free Talk Live.
Bloated belly? Gas? Acid reflux? You could have pounds of rotting, rancid, toxic gunk clogging up your gut right now. And with all the processed food we're exposed to today, it's no wonder why. Fortunately, there's Newbiotics, our first ever gunk buster for cleansing that toxic gunk out of your body. And right now, we're giving away a free trial to anyone who calls the following toll-free number, 1-800-983-2573. Strict limit of one free trial per household. With pounds of toxic gunk clogging up your gut, it's no wonder you don't feel good. Made with natural ingredients, Newbiotics is our first ever gunk buster scientifically designed to unclog your gut and cleanse that gunk from your body, flattening your belly and combating periodic bloating, excess gas, heartburn, and acid reflux. But hurry, call now for your free trial of Newbiotics while we're still giving it away for free. 1-800-983-2573. Call now for details. 1-800-983-2573. That's 1-800-983-2573.
Concerned about harmful contaminants in your water? Look to ProPure, the most trusted name in gravity water filtration systems. ProPure, with the silver-infused Pro-1 G2.0 filter, removes over 200 contaminants, including VOCs, heavy metals, chloramines, pesticides, pharmaceuticals, fluorides, and radiologicals. We don't just say it, we back it up. The Pro-1 G2.0 filter is NSF 42 certified and independently tested to meet NSF BASF-53 and P231 standards. ProPure Water, the way nature meant it to be. Clean, crisp, and refreshing. Purchase with confidence in quality, performance, and customer service. Take advantage of our biggest holiday 25% off sale going on now. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com. Or call 800-544-3533. 800-544-3533.
Free Talk Live.
The amount of young people being brought up on criminal charges, sex offender charges, for taking nude photos of themselves and putting them online. It's just so sad to see these people having their lives just rolled right over the top of by these prosecutors that want to make it look like they're doing something good, but they're not doing anything that's helping anyone. There's no victim in this case. When you hear the term child pornography, what should come to mind, if anything, should be the idea of forcing children into sexual scenes and videotaping or photographing
them. Adults forcing children or somebody...
Even if it's a child forcing another child, it's, I think, the force is the issue there. If you're talking about a 15-year-old girl voluntarily choosing to take a nude photo of herself to send to her boyfriend or to post online, no one forced her to do that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Everything from debt to video game addiction. That's what we've covered tonight. But of course, you can bring up anything that you'd like. That is the point of Free Talk Live. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username LRN.FM. You can join Free Talk Live in real life coming up in about 2 months from tonight. Liberty Forum is happening in 2016, February 18th through the 21st. It's a weekend in Manchester, New Hampshire at the Radisson Hotel, right in the heart of downtown Manchester. It's a great location. And you're going to want to be at this event. Hundreds of like-minded, liberty-oriented folks will be in attendance, and lots of great guest speakers, like Edward Snowden.
Uh-huh.
Well, he's not going to be there in person because, unfortunately, he can't be due to the fact the federal government will have him kidnapped and imprisoned probably for the rest of his life if he shows up on U.S. soil again. So we are going to have him via video link, and he'll be giving a presentation and taking questions.
And it does appear that his glasses are new. His new glasses, the glasses he's sporting these days.
As opposed to the ones from the pictures from 2013?
With the tape holding them together.
NHLibertyForum.com. Go get your tickets now. February 18th through the 21st. It's not just Edward Snowden. There will be dozens of speakers, panel discussions, lots of great things to learn at Liberty Forum, but also the people. That's really what it's all about, is connecting with the Free State Project participants, many of whom have already made the move, like Conan and I, and others who have not yet made the move. There's a lot of people. I would say the majority of attendees to Liberty Forum are people who are still thinking about it, or maybe they've already signed up for the Free State Project, but they haven't yet moved. This is a great opportunity to plug into the community here and get a feel for what it's like to actually be around people who care about freedom on a regular basis. Most of us outside of New Hampshire, most people outside of New Hampshire, don't have any idea what it's like
to be in a place where hundreds of people think like you do and who are relatively nearby. Like if you're in Manchester, there are probably hundreds of libertarians that live in your general area. If you're out here in Keene, probably dozens. Seacoast, likely in the dozens as well. So we've already got over 1,500 people who've moved here as part of the Free State Project, and more are on the way. The Free State Project just hit 90% of its ultimate goal of 20,000 people signed up and pledged. Libertarians, voluntarists to move to New Hampshire and to get active. The Liberty Forum is a great opportunity to meet a whole lot of them. So go to nhlibertyforum.com. Put the video game down for a moment. Go to nhlibertyforum.com and spend a weekend with us where you won't have time to play video games. You won't. You'll be so busy. There's so much going on. You'll barely have time to get enough sleep, you know, especially if you're out late at a party or something like that. And there's certainly no shortage of those going on during the Liberty Forum. NHLibertyForum.com. We'll look forward to seeing you there. Free Talk Live, by the way, going to be broadcasting live from the event. So we were talking about these video game shows, these Let's Plays or the Twitch channel or the Twitch website. What is it, twitch.com or twitch.tv?
Twitch.com. Oh, you know what? I think it is twitch.tv.
Yeah, I've never been.
But I bet you .com will lead you to the same site.
Maybe. You never know about that. Anyway, the sort of the experience of watching another person play video games, I think it's best to watch someone else play a game when you're in the room with them. So I don't mind that at all. If I'm sitting in the room with somebody and they're playing a game, and then, you know, you can interact with the person, talk to that person during that experience, that doesn't bug me. Watching it online, if you can see the person react, then I think it's entertaining. If it's just some raw footage of somebody playing a game, I don't care about that. That doesn't interest me at all. So you're welcome to share your experiences, especially if you've been addicted to video games. And has it affected your life or did it affect your life? What's your story? How did you break out of it? The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Conan, you wanted to share with us, and this has all been kind of building up to this discussion here, a news story about internet gaming disorder.
When you consider how big Twitch is, we've come to a new point in society where, you know, this is video games take up a huge portion of our times, and even people who, you know, our generation and below, everyone knows, you know, we started with the Atari 2600, and
Nintendo.
now they're up to the PS4 and whatnot, and you know, we're PCers. So, I mean,
now Atari's long gone.
Well, yeah, that's how that works.
Somebody bought the brand. I think they're still releasing games.
Thanks, E.T. But so, believe it or not, and of course, you and I knew that this was coming down the pipes, they've created a new disorder for such a situation that people are finding themselves in, and that is compulsive gaming.
Before you go on, just a point about how popular gaming is these days, maybe for our older listeners who aren't sort of with it on this particular topic. I believe it was like within the last 2 years, there was a news headline that video game revenues had exceeded cinema.
I believe it.
Yeah. Meaning
and,
that
and,
there's
when you, and when you look at some of the money that they're pumping into some of these games, they exceed Hollywood
budgets
by far. Oh, yeah. Believe it or not. Yeah. You know, they're and they find, and a lot of these voice actors are straight out of Hollywood, because, I mean, when you're talking about some of these big budget games.
That's true. So I think that's impressive to see that. You know, Hollywood has classically been the go-to entertainment source for Americans. Now that's not so true anymore. Now it's
I think it's dollar for entertainment. People are, you know, the free market is spoken. You know, you can watch a two-hour movie and you can pay, I don't know what it is, go to the movies,
$10 or $12.
Is it 10 or 12? You can pay 20 brand new for a Blu-ray at Walmart or whatever.
Yep.
You could pay 60 for a Fallout 4 that you could spend 200 hours on easy.
Easily.
I mean the money back is just the free market has said this, you know, as far as delivering entertainment value for the buck, the gaming industry's got it down. They've got it nailed.
So where's this story from?
So this is from, well, it originally is, I don't know where it's originally from, but this is at iflscience.com.
The real site.
Not the fake one.
All right.
And it is talking about this new disorder that's coming down the pipes. A new study into the brain connectivity of adolescent boys with a condition called internet gaming disorder, IGD, has revealed a number of irregular patterns suggesting that their brains may be wired differently to those without IGD. This, in turn, is likely to affect their cognition in a variety of ways, some of which may be beneficial, while others are potentially pathological. A According to the American Psychiatric Association, IGD is a new phenomenon that has emerged as a result of the recent expansion of online gaming technology. Sufferers are said to experience symptoms of withdrawal when pulled away from gaming due to the fact that compulsive gaming causes certain pathways in their brains to become triggered in the same direct and intense way that a drug addiction brain is affected by a particular substance, and anything can cause this. You know, people who date frequently and want to get into that dating, the drama and whatnot, or nicotine or caffeine or, you know, any kind of compulsive disorders, you know, withdrawals are
a problem.
Yeah, will fall into the withdrawal symptoms. Where was I at? To learn more about how these pathways are activated, researchers from University of Utah and Chung-Ang University, somewhere in South Korea, sought to compare the neurological activity of 78 adolescents with IGD. I don't know how they proved they had IGD from the get-go, with that of 73 healthy subjects.
Yeah, I don't know that either. I mean, I guess they would just interview them about their video game habits.
I guess someone just saying that, yeah, I have this problem.
What's the first thing you do when you get home from school?
I have withdrawals when I am not able to play video games. And so that makes me...
Not saying you have that problem.
No, the people that...
That's what they're saying.
Yeah, these 78 adolescents that they were able to find.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Internet gaming disorder. Share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We do have Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm with you tonight. It's Ian.
And Conan.
Don't forget, you can visit our website at freetalklive.com. Please, if you support Free Talk Live, help the show out for $5 a month with the Free Talk Live AMP program. You go to amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only Facebook group, which is a super cool thing. And it's actually one of the decent reasons to use Facebook. There aren't a whole lot of reasons to use Facebook, but that's one of them. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. Makes a big difference for us. It allows us to effectively market the program to get on more radio stations around the country, expand our satellite footprint, and bring new internet listeners on board. AMP, A-M-P, amp.freetalklive.com. And now you can use Bitcoin to do your amping if you've been waiting on that. And that actually allows you to be anonymous if you want to. So if you want to totally anonymously amp Free Talk Live, you can now do that. You can sign up for the website with a throwaway email address. Don't use your real name, that kind of thing. And then send us Bitcoin from some anonymous Bitcoin wallet and you'll be good to go. So go to amp.freetalklive.com as we go to your calls and thoughts. More about internet gaming disorder here in moments. First, William in Nevada, you're on Free Talk Live, listening to K-Talks.
Yes, gentlemen. You ever heard of the game Wolfenstein?
Oh, yeah. Huge fan.
Oh, yeah. Good stuff.
Okay. Now, it's interesting. You were shooting Nazis, and there were several layers to go. That was early 90s, I believe.
Yeah, that was when the original Return to Castle Wolfenstein came out. It was actually, I think the original Wolfenstein was an Atari game back in the day, and then the one you were talking about is a first-person shooter, which was sort of the granddaddy of all first-person shooters back in the early 90s, where, you know, it's a first-person perspective, and basically if it moves, you shoot it, and usually you're shooting Nazis or Nazi dogs.
Right, and they had some German language in there, and you had secret passages.
Yep.
I had a gentleman explain to me when I watched a bunch of advertisements around Christmas. This is like, I don't know, 8 years ago, and I said, "Why do they keep advertising the same game with all these weird graphics, and it's a war scenario?" And he told me it's because they want to make the next generation, when they get a gun, not to hesitate.
Do you think there's some kind of conspiracy with the gaming industry and maybe the military-industrial complex?
Just telling you, in the Civil War, they said like 17% or something of the people wouldn't pull a trigger. Okay? I got the gaming magazine, and I was looking through it, and they had like the human half-wit hybrids and steal a car and all this weird stuff. Well, guess who advertises on the inside cover and on the back cover inside?
The military.
The U.S. Army.
They came out with a game once. It was a piece of crap.
Yeah, they had their own game.
Yeah. I don't know if it's any better these days, but it was
junk.
You
know what? I seem to remember reading an article just recently. The Call of Duty guy was saying something right along the lines that you're talking about. You know, it's all about
preparing people to go to war?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I mean, I just don't buy it. I mean, I understand that. I think that the video gamer is an area or like a demographic that can certainly be tapped to go to war. I mean, there are obviously people who
are interested in war and violence and things like that. But anyone who's ever shot a gun knows that it's nothing like that in a video game
as it is
in real life.
I don't think it's so much the Marines that are in the dirt crawling around. I think it's the button pushers. I think it's the drone operators.
That's who they're looking for, you think?
I think these guys are, and it's especially, and it's much easier to pull a trigger when you're, you know, a couple miles up in the sky and you can't see what you're really shooting at. It's just a dot, and it's just a dot that's moving, and you got your crosshairs on it. Yeah, it's a bad guy. They told me it's a bad guy. Push, and there you go. You just bombed the wedding.
So, William, you're right. There is no doubt that the U.S. military is targeting gamers for its marketing campaigns. That much is definitely true.
All right, and there's no recoil when you pull the trigger on a drone unless they program it in.
This is true.
Percussions. You just another dot on the map.
Any other thoughts you want to share, William?
No, but thank you, guys. I love your show. See you later.
Thanks for the call, man. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Wolfenstein, man, great game. I mean, that takes me way back to early 1990s. I was a young teenager when that one came out, if I'd even reached teenage years. It was probably 92.
I put a couple of hours into Wolfenstein, but mine was Doom.
Doom was definitely, yeah, definitely the big one for me, too. But
especially the first time I played it, we were in a LAN network.
Yeah.
So I'd played it a couple of hours here and there, and yeah, this is good stuff.
Where were you at? A French house?
I was at a computer complex.
Would you go to a LAN party?
It wasn't a LAN party. They were actually selling computers and whatnot, it was a huge computer gathering.
Sounds like a LAN party.
It was the way they had the LAN party set up, but it wasn't the entire program.
So it was a larger computer gathering that had a LAN party at it.
They were selling computers and the game.
I see.
This is how they were hooking people.
Neat.
And so I got to sit down and play it for the first time against my competitors who were right next to me.
Yep.
So actually being able to yell at the guy next to me and seeing him on the screen at the same time,
that's
jumping
fun.
Around, it was eye-opening. It was a new experience for sure.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, the kids today are pretty spoiled on this,
oh,
right?
Yeah.
Like, you know, almost every game that comes out has a multiplayer component. That's not true for all of them, but it seems like a big thing these days. And so it's not uncommon to have games where there's 16, 30-plus players that are all in the same map together and all fighting it out. But the difference being that you're not in the same room as those people. And they kind of have adjusted for it by having, like, video game transmission audio. Like, you've got an audio codec that allows you to send instant communications. You're talking to the person rather than having to type it out.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the days of Doom, like you're talking about, if you wanted to talk to the other guys,
you had to type everything.
You had to type it if they weren't there in the room with you. And really, I agree with you, Conan. Doom is truly the father of the first-person shooter, but the grandfather is Wolfenstein. Wolfenstein, the same company that made them. Wolfenstein came before Doom, and the things that Doom brought to the table that Wolfenstein didn't really have was, one, Doom had multiplayer, Wolfenstein did not. So that, I think, really launched Doom into the stratosphere. Doom also had the ability to fake that it was 3D, like actual 3D. In Wolfenstein, you're sort of all on a flat complex, like you never go up stairs or anything like that.
You can't jump.
In Doom, you could go upstairs and like jump off of things, and it looked like you were actually in a 3D world. It was actually sort of an illusion from a technical standpoint, but it was very, very persuasive. So you could play with up to four players in Doom back in the day, and that was like a mind blower, having four people playing in the same game. It was amazing. I remember many hours of my friends and I over at my friend's house, who he actually had a home network with multiple computers in his own home. So we were constantly playing Doom. And the other thing that Doom did that now I think is taken for granted, so besides multiplayer, which is taken for granted, the other thing that Doom did was it created the idea of the mod community, the modification of the stock game. So Doom, there were tools that were released for Doom, not even by the producers. Like, there was third party.
A lot of the early modders were never using the original software. They had to create their own, and they were going in and they were actually essentially hacking the game and adding their own components. So if you wanted to be shooting up Bugs Bunny,
you could change the graphics. Sure, they changed the graphics. They changed the levels. There were some that were called total conversions that changed like every piece of graphic in the game. They changed all of the characters in the game. They changed all the levels. So, I mean, some of these guys would put in a significant number of hours. I mean, I have some experience with it because I did some of the modding myself, being in high school at the time, had plenty of free time for that kind of thing. One of my my most proud modding experiences, Conan, was making a patch that updated all of the Doom monsters. Now, I would have probably been sent to an insane asylum for this if it had happened today, but made all the Doom monsters into teachers and administrators from the school.
Big red flag.
All complete with gory death animations.
That's why you get stopped in the airports every time. It's not because of anything else you've done. It's the damn teachers in the Doom game.
I thought I still had it. I looked around for it a while back, and I couldn't find it. So it's lost to the void, I'm afraid.
They're going to send you away, man.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us here. I even made a level of the school cafeteria as well. It's Free Talk Live.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty HealthShare.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey water filtration systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Pure Life Water, helping you drink better and live better by providing a zero-calorie alternative to sugary drinks. Visit us at nestle-purelife.us. When kids are playing, they often don't want to stop to keep hydrated, so send them out with a bottle of water and encourage them to take frequent drink breaks or call them inside for a quick sip. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Internet gaming disorder. That is a proposal on the table to be added to the DSM, which is the it's basically the list of disorders. I'm sure there's more to it than that. I'm not a psychologist, so I don't spend any time reading that stuff. But that's the proposal that's on the table, and it is about people who are addicted. They're saying adolescent boys here to video gaming, but you know, I would presume that same addiction can continue on into adulthood as well. I mean, the people who are losing their jobs and their wives because of video gaming are definitely of the adult variety. Now, you could argue that they're not very adult in how they behave.
No.
But that's, you know, but physically, they are developed as adults. And so if you want to share your experience, maybe it's with someone who you love who has had an internet or gaming addiction, please dial in toll-free. Maybe it was you, or maybe it is you. Maybe you are hooked right now on something, and you can see that you can't break away from it, or you've been unable thus far to break your habit. You can join us here and share your thoughts.
You know, you're not really an adult in this country anymore until you're 26.
So yeah, I mean
some of these guys got plenty of time. I mean, you're still under mommy's and daddy's healthcare program.
That's true. They did expand that.
And you're going back to live with them at 26, so maybe that's the wrong age.
Some people are staying at their parents' house till their 30s.
Yeah.
So if you want to join us here, we've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. So we've covered everything from some favorite games to the video game, the sort of phenomenon now on YouTube and Twitch, which is apparently a YouTube for gaming. This phenomenon of watching other people play video games, which I kind of understand. Conan, you're not quite as on board with that, even though you have admittedly done so.
To find out where the secret is. I want the secret coin. Where is it? Someone's figured it out. Oh, they did a YouTube video, and I can figure it out, and I can start baking my head up against the keyboard.
And then we were discussing some old games and how they sort of set the table for what was to come later, like Doom.
You mean these disorders?
I think probably there was addiction prior to the games like Doom and Wolfenstein, but I mean, certainly having modding of video games allows for more playable time on a game, so that could, I think, worsen. Like, for me, if I play I don't want to play a massively multiplayer online role-playing game because I know it'll be a problem.
Oh, yeah.
So I won't even I've never done it. I knew a guy who had EverQuest back in the day, a good friend of mine had EverQuest, which is one of the earlier massively multiplayer online role-playing games.
Probably the most successful of the.
Definitely one of the most. World of Warcraft is a big one as well.
Came out much later.
And so EverQuest, man, he was just pouring hour after hour after hour into that, and it never ends. I mean, it's there in the name, EverQuest. I mean, it just keeps going and going. Unfortunately, he ended up passing away, but it wasn't due to, I guess I shouldn't say passing away. He was murdered, but it wasn't due to his video game habits. Nonetheless, I think that I did learn from that, and I thought, gosh, you know, it looks like a cool game, but I don't want to start with that, because at least with a game, even like Fallout, there's an end to that game,
and you can pause it and save your progress at any moment and go get some of your life done.
But that's the problem with that game for me, at least, is my problem is okay, just one more mission. Just one more mission, and before I know it, it's 7 in the morning.
The sun is coming up.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So tell me more about ID. What was it?
IGD, Internet Gaming Disorder. So they scrounged up 78 adolescents with IGD. Who knows how they figured that out? And 73
probably
healthy,
complaints from mom or dad.
Healthy 73 healthy subjects. All participants were between the ages of 10 and 19.
Okay,
and they were all from South Korea, which I understand has a pretty epic gaming problem.
Yep.
You know, they got gaming TV and stuff, gaming
There's
TV stations.
There's people that die in South Korea and China and some
or their
of those
kids
places.
Die or they're, you know, because they're not being taken care of and, you know.
Well, like specifically the gamers, there's like at least once a year there's a headline that we'll see, and maybe there's more headlines over there. I was just on one of these sites looking at some gaming stuff, and there's a headline about a guy who was in a internet cafe for 3 days straight. And who basically died from exhaustion.
And I wonder if he had mommy with the poop bucket underneath him, like in the South Park episode.
I haven't seen that.
It's the World of
Video Games?
It's the World of Warcraft episode.
Ah, okay.
So anyways, they took these guys that they scrounged up. The team used magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, to observe the connectivity between 25 different brain regions while the subjects were at rest. Results indicated that patients with IGD displayed increased connectivity between seven pairs of regions, suggesting a number of potential implications for cognitive function. And it goes into some of that way their eyes were connecting with their brain and all, and there's a lot of big words. I'm going to skip that. In a statement, study co-author Jeffrey S. Anderson explained the hyperconnectivity between these brain networks could lead to a more robust ability to direct attention towards targets and to recognize novel information in the environment. So this is the good stuff. This is likely to improve gamers' performance when playing video games, although more importantly, it could also enhance their ability to execute real-world tasks.
If they can put the game controller down.
If they can go outside in the real world and actually, or maybe these are the drone operators we're talking about. So, however, publishing their findings in the journal Addiction Biology, the researchers revealed that not all these enhanced connections are quite so beneficial. In particular, they note that increased communication between the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, which plays an important role in working memory, and another region of a brain involving the focusing of attention, may well produce harmful effects. For instance, over-connectivity between these regions is thought to provoke symptoms such as increased distractibility and poor impulse control, and is often seen in sufferers of psychiatric conditions, including autism and schizophrenia.
Increased distractibility. Now, I mean, arguably, young people today are more distracted than ever. I mean, even without video games in the picture.
But they're supposed to be able, because of all this, because of the information overload, they've got their eye on a screen everywhere they look. They're supposed to be able to...
You're gesturing with your hands. I don't know exactly.
Handle many situations at once.
Multitask.
Yeah, there you go. Are they really able to? Because some studies are saying they can't focus on anything. Are they able to? Yeah, they focus on one thing and they're immediately distracted by the kitty meme on Facebook.
I mean, ultimately, you can't really multitask, right? Like, you can only do, just like a computer processor, you can only really do one thing at a time. The computer appears to be doing more than one thing at a time, but ultimately,
my RAM, Ian, I'm able to do multiple tasks at once. I mean, it seems like, I'm only focusing on one, but I'm doing them so quickly that I'm able to do a lot of tasks and I can run some in the background. Yeah, a computer can run things in the background all the time.
It's not really my understanding. Look, I'm not a computer engineer, but my understanding of the way now with multi-cores, it's sort of a different situation. Like now we have processors that have multiple cores in them, and I think that changes how this works. But given one computer core, one processor, that processor is linear. It's doing one thing at any moment. It's just doing it so quickly that you can't tell that it's one thing at any moment. So in any given, let's say, 60 clock ticks on the processor, if you are, you're on your web browser, but behind your web browser there's a word processing application, or behind that there's some memory manager program or whatever, you know, of those 60 clicks, you know, probably 50 out of the 60 are going to the word processor. But, you know, 5 out of the 60 are going to the majority of them are going to the thing that's in the front of the screen, and the other clock ticks are going to the things that are going on in the background.
Right.
So it's to you and I, it appears as though it's doing more than one thing at once, but ultimately the processor itself is just prioritizing certain traffic.
Well, what I'm getting from this, it seems like these autistic types, because that's really what I think it boils down to, can sit in front of a screen for 8 hours straight, just playing, just prodding on through. And I think that some of them are maybe having difficulties when they walk outside the door. And so it seems like they're taking care of all of these different components. They're going every which direction. I got all these things in mind, but they walk out the door and they're struck by real life, by reality, and they're not able to cope because it's not linear. There's more options involved
in real life.
Whereas the game, it's a game. I mean, there are rules.
Yep.
You know, if I go over there and shoot that guy that's bigger than me, he's going to shoot back. And, you know, if only people could put the video game rules into the equation, and the real life,
If only real life were that simple.
That easy, that linear.
Now, of course, video games are trying to be less linear. You've got games like Grand Theft Auto and Fallout, the Fallout series.
Sandbox, where it's just anything goes.
Open world, so to speak, or at least the appearance that anything goes. You can go in whichever direction you want to, and there are a lot of different options of things to do, but there are still limitations to those systems. The computer characters aren't particularly believable as real life entities or whatever. But we're going to see that change over time, yeah, as artificial intelligence becomes a thing. And then all kinds of interesting questions will get answered, or will, I think, more new questions will arise.
We're going to be going down another level of the matrix.
Well, yeah, the big question is, at what point does artificial intelligence become real intelligence, and does it, when do they get rights? And we'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime. FreeTalkLive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com.
Silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts and Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, December 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,080 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $440. Antiwar.com reports coalition airstrikes against the major the Islamic State held Iraqi city of Mosul leveled homes in a residential neighborhood on Monday, killing at least 20 people, including at least 12 civilians. The claim was that the homes were used by the Islamic State. Witnesses said one of the houses belonged to the son of a local the Islamic State commander. Several other houses in the area were badly damaged by the attacks, and officials have conspicuously not commented on the incident so far. U.S. officials have generally not admitted to large civilian death tolls during airstrikes against the Islamic State territory, insisting the reports of eyewitnesses in those areas are not credible and refusing to investigate the claims more thoroughly. Mosul is the largest city of the Islamic State and has been held by the Islamic State since the summer of 2014. Though U.S. and Iraqi officials have talked up the eventual counterattack, there is no timetable for trying to reclaim the city, which is still deeply entrenched in the Islamic State's territory. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. UPI reports the U.S. Food and Drug Administration on Monday overturned a rule banning gay men from donating blood, but will still impose some restrictions. The FDA's lifetime ban on blood donations from gay and bisexual men that's been in effect for 32 years has been lifted, but a new policy will ban men from donating blood if they've had sex with another man in the previous year. The lifetime ban was put in place amid the AIDS crisis. The FDA said in a statement the decision was made to reflect the most current scientific evidence and to help ensure continued safety of the blood supply by reducing the risk of human immunodeficiency virus transmitted by blood and blood products. The FDA said it will continue to reevaluate blood donor deferral policies whenever new scientific information becomes available. Critics of the new policy have said that gay men are still effectively banned from donating blood because they must be abstaining from sex, but the agency said it does not have research to loosen the regulation any further than the 12-month ban. Among other groups subject to the same 12-month ban in order to reduce the risk of HIV and AIDS transmission includes heterosexuals who have used intravenous drugs or had sex with prostitutes in the previous 12 months.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a Baltimore police officer will face retrial on manslaughter charges over the death of Freddie Gray starting on June 13th, according to a Maryland judge on Monday after the officer's first trial ended in a deadlocked jury. The Maryland State Court's office said in a statement that Judge Barry Williams set the trial date after meeting prosecutors and defense lawyers. Gray's death in April caused protest in the city and intensified U.S. debate on police treatment of minorities. The date for the retrial of Officer William Porter in Baltimore City Circuit Court could snarl prosecutors' strategy to use him as a key witness against other officers in the high-profile trial. Porter was the first of six officers to be tried in connection with Gray's death from a broken neck sustained while in police custody. A jury was unable to reach a decision last week, and Williams declared a mistrial. Porter faces charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, reckless endangerment, and misconduct in office. The trial of the van driver, Officer Caesar Goodson, who faces the most serious charge of second-degree depraved heart murder, is set to begin on January 6th. Prosecutors had hoped to convict Porter and use him as a witness against Goodson and Sergeant Alicia White. Porter testified he passed Gray's request for medical help to them, but none was summoned. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The American robin heralds the beginning of spring in temperate climates across North America. Its red breast makes it easily identifiable as the most disturbingly efficient murderer in the animal kingdom. Robins inculcate their young with these twisted maws. We see an adult robin feeding its young with the ripped apart viscerae of an innocent worm. Like the Greek hero Atreus eating the flesh of his children at his own table, this black deed must surely curse the entire species. Even the most depraved acts of humanity pale in comparison to the robin's wickedness. Like idiot rapists, they commit their foul deeds with neither foresight nor hindsight. They live entirely in the present. Living beyond space and time, their god is the awful seething maelstrom of chaos at the center of the unfeeling universe.
This is the Onion News Network.